From Charlottetown, it is Island Storm Basketball NBL Canada action on 5TV1. This evening, it's the Island Storm playing host to the top team in the Atlantic Division, the Halifax Hurricanes. How you doing, everybody? Peter Ruckgazer alongside Gord Neely. Glad you can join us tonight. Well, Gord, the Island Storm, they played last night in St. John, and they beat a real good Riptide team. You saw that game. Your thoughts on the contest?
Well, they moved the ball really well. They had a good, strong fourth quarter. Normally, that's been their Achilles heels, that fourth quarter. They played strong, got buckets. Al Richter had a good game. They had a good game all over the board for the first starting seven or so. So they're going to have to make that trip in playoffs and beat a tough St. John team, so it'll boost their confidence, and that was a big win for them.
As for Halifax, they too played last night. They played Cape Breton at home. They beat them no problems, 121-66. This is a team, they've ran roughshod over basically everybody in this division. They've known for a long time they're going to win the division. How important right now is it for head coach Mike Leslie to keep his troops focused?
Well, that's the name of the game. You got to keep them focused. They have the talent there for sure. They've had a great season. Listen, 5-5 down the last stretch isn't necessarily what Mike Leslie wants. So he's got to keep them ready to go. If the Storm can hang in there, this fourth quarter is going to be really, really interesting today.
Halifax, they have dominated the Storm this season. They are 7-1 against the Island Storm. We're going to take a break right now. On the other side, starting lineups and the opening tip. You're watching Island Storm Basketball on 5TV1.
Hey, Mom, is it okay if Sarah comes over for dinner tonight?
Yeah, as long as it's okay with her mom.
Can she?
Yeah, of course.
Yes!
At Ronald McDonald House, we give families a home away from home, close to their sick children.
Oh, sorry.
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 Oh! Sorry.
Sorry. Hi, Quinn.
When Nana visits, everyone's happy to see her.
We all know how quickly kids can get into things, and that's why we keep poisons locked up. But have you ever considered what's in your purse? Things like hand sanitizers, tobacco, coins, and medication are all poisoning risks for small children. That's why we should keep handbags out of reach.
It's a simple habit that will help keep our kids safe.
Yeah!
For more information on preventing children's injuries, visit childsafetylink.ca.
There's nothing faster than light. Fiber optic uses light to deliver the internet. It's the fastest internet technology. So you can share, learn, stream, or do whatever you want at the speed of light. And only Bell brings fiber optic internet right to your home.
Bravo. Yes, indeed.
This is going to make your world a lot different than the one I grew up in.
Do you know where England is?
Sure, it's over there.
And over there is where that sound is coming from. Right, Mr. Marconi?
Through the air, across the ocean, the first time ever.
Wouldn't it be nice to have a big brother?
So what you want to do this weekend?
I want to go to the Canada Game Center. I want to go swimming on the big yellow slide, which goes outside.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
Yeah.
Definitely do that for sure.
Yeah. I have to go bowling too.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Kids with mentors grow up to be more successful adults. Supporting Big Brothers Big Sisters is a great way to have a positive impact on your community. To volunteer or make a donation, go to BigBrothersBigSisters.ca.
Imagine pedaling your bike every day, going to Carpoon to Lance Mendels. We've been all over the place here. We went in every nook and cranny and climbed across the roof and hung on the beam. You know what young fellas like. When this is here, you come and explore. My character is Ragnar, and my role is a blacksmith. Talk about where the Vikings got their iron and smelt it down and turn it into nails. The Vikings. Yeah, I think they're still here.
Like me back.
Like his friend.
Good idea. Can you forge my mom's signature?
I can, but will I? No.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Storm Chasers dance. Welcome back, everybody, to Charlottetown. And we're about ready to get going here in a couple of minutes as the Island Storm take on the Halifax Hurricanes. Let's send it down now to PA announcer Paul M. Skuurman.
From San Diego State University, a 6'9 forward, number 23, Billy White. From the University of Alabama at Birmingham, a 6'7 forward, number 20, C.J. Washington. From DePaul University, a 6-foot guard, number 12, Cliff Clinkscale. From New Mexico State University, a 6'6 forward, number 1, Tyrone Watson. And from Auburn University, a 6'3 guard, number 14, Antoine Mason. The head coach of the Halifax Hurricanes, Mike Leslie. Assistant coaches, Chris Angentine and Joe Wells. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to introduce the All-Star Pressing starting lineup for your Island Storm, please welcome to center court, Cowboy Mike Hughes.
Before the playoffs, let's send them off with all your energy.
So there's tons of energy in the house here tonight in Charlottetown as we get set the final home game in the regular season for the Island Storm as they take on their nemesis, the Halifax Hurricanes. We talked about it in the pregame, Gord. Storm 1-7 against Halifax, and they've been close games. The only game that was really out of reach, which was a blowout, was back on January the 29th, a 120-102 win for Halifax. Other than that, the Storm have just been there, very close against a very excellent team from Halifax.
Yeah, and what Halifax does so well is they rebound the ball. They out-rebound the other teams dramatically in rebounding. So we'll see if the Storm can control the glass at home and see if this Halifax team is ready to play playoff basketball yet. They know they're in. They know they're going to finish first place, but it's hard to get up for these games. But these guys are professionals for a reason. And, you know, the Halifax fans have seen this team perform night in, night out. So big shout out to the Halifax fans watching tonight.
The thing for the Island Storm, as you said, the size factor. They're a bigger team than the Island Storm. They have to make sure that Halifax doesn't get those second chance points. I was talking to Coach Leslie. His concern, conversely, is, you know, the Storm, they play small. They're a small team, yeah, and they can run. He wants to try to slow them down a little bit.
Yeah, and Terry Thomas will attack you from the three position. They're 1-2 score a lot for the Storm. Listen, Billy White's their five guy and scoring the most points for them, so we'll see if they can control him off the glass. That's going to be the key to the game.
Yeah, Billy White, he is a matchup problem for this Island Storm team, and we are underway. As you see, Clink Scales setting the table here. There's Antoine Mason. And there's Billy White. His shot's no good. Nice rebound by Watson. And there, that's an example of what the Island Storm have to do. They have to rebound the ball. That shot coming up short there by C.J. Washington.
Yeah, and Akeem Ellis is 6'6 versus Billy White's 6'9. So we'll see what happens there.
Jahi Carson gets the party started as he knocks it down for two.
And that's a really tough matchup for Akeem, but he plays tough on defense. He plays above his size. So, and they're getting that ball inside. C.J. Washington makes trouble for opposing teams as well.
Good rejection there defensively by Terrell Baines. Ritger with that outside shot. Ritger went off last night, 5 of 8 from three-point land in that 104-92 victory against St. John. Watson back to the bucket. Clink Scale, being watched there by Jahi Carson. They tried the alley-oop, and getting the conversion there is C.J. Washington. He made the little adjustment there.
Yeah, it was just at the high post, and the weak side high post spun off of that and was wide open. So interior post scoring is going to be an issue here for the Storm. They have to nip it right away.
Mason. Oh, great passing and an easy bucket there by Watson.
And you can put up a lot of points in a hurry by making that extra pass and scoring with your fours and fives. So, again, that could be the issue tonight.
Baines going baseline with that shot and drains it.
And here the Storm have to get back and set their defense right away. Know where everybody is. And if you're going to switch, but you make sure you communicate.
Keem Ellis trying to guard Billy White. That's a tough assignment. Watson. And they lose a handle on it. And here comes Terry Thomas. Thomas trying to drive. Lays it in off the glass.
What an individual play. Stealing the ball. Making sure he put it in his dominant hand. Slowing down to finish. Amazing. Terry Thomas having a great season.
Averaging 18.9 points. 6.7 rebounds. Shooting 45.6% from the field. Antoine Mason, the jumper. Can't get it to go. 6-4 lead early going here from Charlottetown.
Any of you the Hurricanes, you can get a better shot than that. So you got to move the ball once more and then try to get a little bit of a crisper shot.
And Terry Thomas hitting the tray.
And for a streaky shooter playing the three, once you hit a layup like that from a steal, your confidence grows, and then bang, the next three goes in. Better closeouts there by the Storm.
Inside for Watson, and he gets fouled.
You see the steal there. Bumps off the contact. It's in his dominant hand now. Slows down right there. Gets his footing. And then finishes. That's what he does better than anybody in the league. Just attacks the basket efficiently.
And he loves to play against Halifax. Halifax is hometown. And you can be sure that Mike Leslie, they want to clamp down on him here this evening.
And Watson just went 1-for-2 at the line there. But everything that the Halifax Hurricanes have done thus far has been post-oriented. So, and they're getting great shots.
Two-man Carson, a floater. That rimmed out. Shahi Carson, 7 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists last night in that victory. So nice to see that the Island Storm didn't have to rely totally on Jahi Carson offensively to get a victory against a real good St. John team.
Exactly. When he doesn't have to do as much of the scoring and other guys are in the rotation, that's when Al Richter's coming in scoring, Terry Thomas is active, and then Nakeem Ellis, they can take a little bit of that scoring and Jahi can just work on selectively scoring.
What was good about last night's victory? One of the things that was good, you have Rashad Wack. His biggest game since coming back to the Storm here from Switzerland, 23 points. He was 6 of 12 from the field. So nice to get contributions from everybody in the lineup.
Yeah, and you've got Al Stewart coming off the NBL Player of the week before. So they're getting great guard play in the 1-2 and touching on the 3 spots. So, you know, keep it going. Just make sure your defense is there collectively.
Here's the aforementioned Terry Thomas. Akeem Ellis from deep. And we've seen that so many times.
Yeah, he was way back there. He loves shooting those long, deep threes. And he's very good at it. So there's not much you can do to defend that.
12-7 lead for the Storm here. As you take a look at Billy White, boy, he is a matchup problem for this Storm team.
Look at this three. Watch where his feet are.
Wow, he's way back.
Way back there. And then, so he's shooting that three, and then he comes back down, and he's guarding the interior post defender. So that means that their interior post defender is not going out to guard that. So a nice chess match here between these two teams.
Not in the lineup tonight for the Island Storm is A.J. Stewart. He continues to have that problem with the foot, and he will not play the rest of the regular season. They hope to have him healed up in time for the playoffs. They brought in Sam Zaglinski, who was cut by Niagara. He's a point guard, a shooting guard as well. Inside for Baines.
Oh.
Baines totally rejected right there and then stays with the process and gets the bucket. Hey. Initially, that was blocked by C.J. Washington.
Yeah, great action. Just a nice play, a set play by the Storm. And good contest at the rim. Like you said, this Halifax team is big, and they play big.
Terry Thomas trying to get a step on Watson. Now Baines has it. Ellis was thinking about shooting a long three there. Here's Jahi Carson.
Oh, did he ever exploit that mismatch? Whoa. And basketball fans will see how skillful that last, just that little hesitation, and then froze his defender. And that was against C.J. Washington. So it was just on a mismatch or, you know, you have to guard whoever you're guarding in the area and bang.
Halifax team played last night an easy 121-66 victory against Cape Breton. Cape Breton, without 3 of their starters, a depleted team, a number of injuries on that team. So it was pretty easy for Halifax to win that contest.
Yeah, and C.J. Washington better be careful. He just picked up 2 fouls in a row. Watch this. He's going to go right, and then the body contact here. And so he's going to have an early exit to this game, and you don't want to see a big man picking up 2 fouls early. But good thing for the Storm, because he's a great player, C.J. Washington.
So Washington has to sit. Coming in is Anthony Cox, the former Harlem Globetrotter, played for them for 5 seasons. Inside for Baines. And there's Billy White. Boy, I mean, everybody thinks that Billy White is just an offensive player, but he is so versatile.
No, if you just watched him there on that play before that, he gets back from away and he's getting up. That wasn't even the best thing he did in that defensive transition. He bumped his man who was going to set a screen off that screen so easily. It was like he was just, you know, moving somebody out of the way. It was pretty amazing. Strength, size, speed, and power.
Storm off to a good start here, 14-9. 6:40 remaining in the first quarter. Mason working against Terry Thomas. He gets a screen, wants the drive, and that pass trying to hook up there with Cox, and a little miscommunication there.
Yeah, and they're just trying to watch to see if the Storm's switching a lot of these screens. That was a good, nice set by Mike Leslie's team. Had a flex start cut to the beginning and then a ball screen, so they run good stuff, Halifax. You got to be defending at all times.
Terry Thomas wants the drive, and Terry Thomas has got his mojo going.
You saw how good that was, and that's going to his weak hand, so he doesn't really have a weak hand. Tough to defend Terry Thomas. Great player.
Watson. Inside for Cox. A little too strong off the window. Back the other way, Terry Thomas. He'll hold up. Set things in the half court. No, Akeem Ellis wants to shoot. And Baines couldn't get that rebound. Here's Clink Scales.
Oh,
whips
nice pass.
A pass. Wow. That was from midcourt.
With his left hand. Talented point guard.
One thing that Coach Leslie said, that he wants Clink Scales take a few more shots. He's a very unselfish player.
He's only averaging 4.5 points a game. He's a pass-first point guard. And with this team, it's worked so far. But when you're 5-5 in your last few games, maybe the point guard needs to assert himself a little bit more. There's the foul. So they're in foul trouble right now, Halifax is.
So there you have it. 5:24 remaining in the first quarter. We're going to step out. Island Storm leading Halifax by a score of 16-11. Back to Charlottetown in just a bit.
Being part of an Easter Seals camp has really shaped who I am today. My dream is to see every kid in Canada living with a disability go to an Easter Seals camp so they can experience what I have experienced. See ability in disability. See the difference? Be the difference.
Text Easter to 45678. Make your $10 donation today.
Storm Basketball on 5TV1 is brought to you by Graphcom Group. Design, web, marketing, we're here to help you be great. Peter Ruckgazer alongside Gord McNeely and the entire 5TV1 crew. 5:24 remaining in the first quarter, and it's a Storm with a 5-point lead over the Halifax Hurricanes. Just your initial thoughts so far, Gord, and what you've seen here. A pretty good start for the Storm.
Yeah, a pretty good start. Terry Thomas is hot. He's got 7 points on 3-for-3 shooting. That's what Halifax is talking about. You got to control his penetration. I'm watching to see how the Storm are defending Halifax's pick and roll, picking their high pick with their 4 or 5 guys on versus their one-handed dribbler. So we'll see how they defend that. Thus far, I haven't seen great things. They're switching a little bit late. So we'll watch that and see if it's a factor.
Jahi Carson. Into the game now is Mike Allison. He had a very good performance last night against St. John.
Yeah, and you see Billy White there. He got a little bit closer to Akeem Allison and affected that shot. And that was the screen we were talking about, because I noticed that Halifax set that screen aggressively and strong, and they got called for it there. So that's what I'm watching for to see how the Storm defend that. Well defended there, and it's going the other way.
Looking for Mike Allison's stats from last night. 6 points, or excuse me, 9 points, 6 rebounds, 5 of 5 from the free throw line. So when you get that type of production and, you know, with limited minutes from your big man, that's pretty good. Mm.
And they're going to call another foul on Cox. So what Halifax is doing is they're being over physical and trying not to let the person set the screen, and they're getting called for it. So they've got to watch that because they're just racking up the fouls now. They're up to six fouls in the first 15 minutes. So the refs aren't happy about that, and could be a factor down the stretch of this game.
So Ellis comes out, States is in. You've got Rashad Black also into the contest. And Allison, there's Terry Thomas. Allison looking for the tip, couldn't get it. Billy White over to Poole. And
they're going to call it on States.
Foul on States, okay. Yeah. Away from the ball.
And that was just, he was defending the post and got a little bit too physical. So the refs are trying to make a statement. Hey, you know what? No hands tonight.
Clink scales.
Look at that screen. That screen is some extra mustard there.
There's Watson. He stays with it. Watson off the window. So there you go. A situation where Storm can't seem to block out. Mm-hmm. Guys like Watson and Billy White so far in this game. Long shot from Wack, no good. There's White with a rebound. Alley-oop pass. And I don't think Cox could stay in bounds. No, he couldn't.
And you know what? They're, Billy White is a new kind of physical for the Island Storm. Jahi Carson did not like that physicality on that screen because he just held it. You know, when a player sets a screen, you're supposed to set it and then move on. But you're not supposed to hold that screen and hold that player there. So we'll watch to see what develops from that.
Al Stewart into the game. Here's States with a long three. Al Stewart, what a week he had last weekend. Became the all-time leading scorer for the Storm.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Then had a triple-double. So that was an unbelievable weekend that the veteran had.
One of the best games I've seen by any player in this league ever. A 30-point triple-double.
Yeah.
that's insane. Brad States just stepped in and took a massive charge there. Al Stewart directed him right to the point, and Brad States took a beautiful charge. So big minutes, big plays by your bench thus far.
States has done a lot of that this season in his first pro campaign. And that's going to be Halifax ball.
And Mike Allison working hard for offensive rebounds, but Cox is just, he's just good at balking out. Anthony Cox, just very physical. Things that you don't see on TV, just really knows how to use his body.
Billy White thought about shooting it. Gets it in the paint for Cox. Turnaround shot, that's beautiful.
Yeah, and he's just using his body. That shot came because he did the homework before. And hard to defend a player that's that physical and that good at it. See what's... The messing around there at the top, that's because Billy White's being physical.
That was Rashad Wack. Drove and laid it in. Storm by three. Billy White wants to drive on Allison and does. Whoa, he made that look very easy. And hey, Mike Allison is a real good defensive player.
Yeah, it's just not used to that kind of speed and that kind of dribbling skills. There's that screen. There's some nice side stories. Look at that rebound off a block.
Thomas with a teardrop. So Terry Thomas getting it done here for the Island Storm in this first quarter.
He's going to try it again. Watch this. Oh, boy.
Oh, what a crossover. And there's White, stays with it. Cox has it. And a little bit of tug of war there between Cox and Terry Thomas.
And that's what we're talking about, Peter. We're watching so many little side stories happening, starting to happen here that could brew all night long. Look at him, Billy White with a great drive, gets his own offensive rebound. They're fighting for it. Watch this. This is a rhino. It's two rhinos going at it. I don't even know what they would have called there. I think it was jump ball. And he's upset. He thought he got fouled there.
But basically, that's what the Island Storm have. They have to try to win the battle under on the glass, don't they?
Oh, they have to win it. They have to be. They have to either shoot very well or win the battle of the glass. And they've been shooting well. So I'm not too worried till the fourth quarter. Depends on who wins the fourth quarter rebounding situation.
Here's Poole. Zimmerman. Inside. Haywood. Nice touch there by Haywood, the former St. Mary's Husky.
Yeah, he's gotten better offensively. And that showed you right there. He was getting ridden pretty hard and then finished strong.
Ball going all over the place. Here's Allison tried to float it in. And play a little scrambly there. Billy White, he is pumped up.
Yeah, he's pumped up and they're going at it. Him and Cox play really well together. It's like a gangster mentality of basketball, and it works pretty well.
Billy White, former San Diego State player, played in the NBA D League. Also played in the Israeli League, so he's a veteran. He's been around. 1 minute now remaining in this first quarter. Here's Cox, low post. Comes back to him again, spins on Allison, and he can't sink it. Back the other way, here's Al Stewart. Whack, wide open for three. And he knocks it down.
And like we said, Peter, you either rebound well or you shoot the ball well. When you shoot the ball like that, good things will happen. Give him 4-point lead.
23-19, 27 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Zimmerman, he's going to try a three. That's short. White gets the rebound, loses it, retains it again, and is fouled.
We could talk about even just that offensive rebound for about 5 minutes. The way he got in close when both people jumped, he physically was stronger, driving his person under the basket, more room to rebound, and there it is. So that's what makes him so good. Yeah, you can tell he's pumped, he's ready to roll. And that kind of has an intimidation factor too. And you need to send somebody out there and to give him a few whacks around to maybe bring that out of him, because this is your home. You can't be intimidated at home.
What's amazing about Billy White, check this out, from the field, his percentage, 62.2% from the field. That is simply out of this world. I had to take a double take, yeah. And then I had a chance to sit down and talk to Coach Leslie. He said, yeah, that's correct. Yeah.
It's just the way you use your body. If you're in the weight room and you think that you are the best player, it's a good combination.
It's an amazing field goal percentage. And here, Longley pass, but time has run out on Haywood. So, entertaining first quarter of play between these two Atlantic Division rivals. The Storm, they have a 23-21 lead over Halifax. We're going to take a break. Coming back with second quarter action right here on 5TV1.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry. Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Oh! Sorry.
When Nana visits, everyone's happy to see her.
We all know how quickly kids can get into things, and that's why we keep poisons locked up. But have you ever considered what's in your purse? Things like hand sanitizers, tobacco, coins, and medication are all poisoning risks for small children. That's why we should keep handbags out of reach.
It's a simple habit that will help keep our kids safe.
Yeah!
For more information on preventing children's injuries, visit childsafetylink.ca.
What if he doesn't like me back?
Like his friend.
Good idea. Can you forge my mom's signature?
I can, but will I? No.
Welcome back, everybody. You're probably wondering what's going on here. They're singing the national anthem. We're into the second quarter, getting ready for the... Well, apparently, this group of school children, they got here late to the rink, and they were supposed to sing the national anthem. Everybody in the crowd sang it. I was wondering what was going on, so they got to the rink late. They allowed them to sing the national anthem just before we started the second quarter, so a nice touch there.
And it's great. That's what makes PEI great, I think. It's just everybody stops what they're doing, bring the kids out, and let them. The kids from Morale came all the way down here, so it's great. They probably took a bus or two for a late game, so good for them. That's a great Islander thing to do.
Nice touch by the Storm. So getting ready for second quarter action. 23-21 in favor of the Storm. Take a look at some highlights. Mm-hmm.
Gee, there, and it's the battle inside that we talked about, and that's what's kept Halifax in this game. Really strong inside play. You know, everybody's getting a touch, and they're being more physical than the Storm right now. So, great job. Terry Thomas came out strong, quick 7 points. And when you're three guys hitting threes like that, beautiful basketball.
Keem Ellis with that deep three that we've seen so many times since he's joined the team. And there's Billy White.
Yeah, he's playing a little volleyball.
And Terry Thomas, he's been on his game here. He played last night against St. John. The game before, he missed that one because of the back hip injury, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
And so he looks to be okay.
And then Wax really come on strong there. Rashad Wax, really good, but looking for a physical second quarter, especially in the inside interior post play for the Island Storm.
No problem here with the clock, and they'll get that adjusted. Terry Thomas leading the way, 9 points for the Storm, 4 or 5 from the field, and leading things off for Halifax, it is Tyrone Watson. He has 7 points on 3 of 4 from the field.
And they're patient with their screening action. There's that screen. See, you got caught in between there. And you can't get caught in there in guarding nobody. So that's what Halifax does. They make you pay.
Nice little roll there for C.J. Watson. Game tied at 23. Al Stewart. He's got Zimmerman on him.
And they're not giving him any space. They're really... stuck to Stewart. They don't want him to get started tonight.
Three ball is no good. Poole has it. Here's a person that Mike Leslie's been depending on of late over the last couple of weeks. Zimmerman, nice pass inside there for CJ Washington. And Washington's starting to feel a little bit for Halifax.
And it's not being guarded well at all, Peter. And it's a double screen, and to get whatever you want coming off of it. Things got to change on that defense right there. And they're better than that. They know they're just not reacting. They're not trusting each other. So we see just a little broken play there. And then, it goes off of Halifax. So here we go. 15 on the shot clock.
Carson is in there with Ellis. They've come back in, and there's Akeem Ellis makes his presence felt coming back into the contest.
And the Halifax Hurricanes are going to go back to this play. They just got it. Yeah.
Oh, nice shot there by Haywood.
Now you're not guarding the inside. Now the perimeter player just hit a three. You're in big trouble right now defensively.
Terry Thomas wants to drive. Yeah. Terry Thomas, anytime he wants to score, it seems like he can score here in this one so far.
And they're asking for a screen. This is going to be a double screen. See, there's two guys. They're just a little bit scrambly.
Haywood wide open. No good. Rebound by Poole. Halifax boy, they are tough off the glass here. They're just eating up this Island Storm team in terms of rebounds and second chance points.
Well, you know what? When you're moving so well offensively, you lose both your defensive assignment and your rebounding assignment. And if you lose your rebounding assignment against this Halifax team, that's what happens. They're just setting up. It's like they're setting up at the KOA campground. And they're waiting for the party.
So a three-point lead now for Halifax. Basically just underway here in the second quarter from Charlottetown. 9:47 remaining in the second. Here's Ellis. Ellis puts up a prayer and gets fouled, and he'll head to the line.
And their individual one-on-one play is keeping them in it. First 3 minutes of this game, watch this. Wrong foot. Whoa. Yeah, I'll shoot that. Wrong foot going downwards. Just a nice play. I don't think it'll make the highlight reel, but it's nice to have those 3 points here.
It was a wing and a prayer there from Hakeem Ellis.
He's crafty like that, though. He's a scorer, and he knows how to get the ball going to the basket. Yeah. So it's all about defense right here for the Storm. Guarding this pick.
Ellis had 18 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists last night in St. John in that victory against the Riptide. There's C.J. Washington. As you saw the physicality right there from Washington. Man.
And you see the adjustment. I'll talk to you about the adjustment after when we get a chance, Peter.
Here's Baines. No good. Brought down, and now Haywood going to bring it up the floor and then loses the handle on it.
So fast he crossed himself over.
Ellis. Terrell Baines from the corner. He's done that a couple of times here this evening so far.
Points off of turnovers.
And now coming into the game, eventually here will be Sam Zielinski. There's Poole. That was a tough shot, and there's Billy White. Billy White's going to get charged with a foul there.
And maybe that's a reason why the Island Storm people are falling so far into the basket. The refs caught a push off there on the weak side.
So there is Sam Zielinski. He used to play here a couple of years back. He was cut by Niagara. He's a one or a two, and he's going to fill in for.
And you know why they're bringing him now is because they did that adjustment I was talking to you about. They guarded the top of the point guard with Al Stewart. So Zielinski's going to come in and guard that right now. So they want his defense to stop that screen at the top that Halifax has been doing so well.
Here's Jahi Carson, that short. Bringing him to replace A.J. Stewart, who's out with that foot injury. So
they want him to fight through that screen hard right there. They want him to create some dynamic defense there at the top and really fight his way through it, because Jahi Carson is getting 35, 36 minutes. He can't do everything. So they're playing him off the ball.
And again, a little miscommunication there. Zielinski, he played for Coach Salerno, so they know each other. Coach Salerno said that he was trying to find a big out there, but couldn't come to terms on an agreement with some bigs that he was looking at. So decide, hey, I'm just going to get a player that I'm familiar with and can play for me. Knows the system a little bit. Here's Watson. Whoa, that's a tough shot. Can't get it to go. And now Jahi Carson will push it. Carson, he'll hold up a little bit. Baines is going to try this jumper, and Baines, wow, he's got the hot hand.
And we know he can hit that shot up here. We've seen it a million times, that same four, and he's very good at it. And that's a huge thing when your player can draw, when you can bring the defense out away with your big man.
34-30 lead for the Storm. And it's a foul there on Zielinski.
It's a pretty deep, like, that's his feet were on the white line, which would be the inside three-point line, the U.S. college three-point line. So that's a pretty deep shot, a 20-foot shot. On the other end, it's rotational stuff on defense that time. And Halifax is so good at making you look to the left, and all the stuff's going to happen from the right. So you've really got to stick together. All five guys have to play defense at the same time. This game feels like it's going to be up in the 110, 120s here.
And Haywood is called for foul. He wants a little clarification from the referee.
Haywood's such a competitor. I loved him at St. Mary's and here too as well. He just competes.
Two-time NBL Canadian of the Year, AUS Player of the Year in 2011. So he's got some hardware. Here's Akeem Ellis again from way downtown. Boy, that was in another zip code.
And his tongue was wagging. He's excited, man. That's another deep bomb.
That's two of them that he's had here this evening. Watson. Taking it in. And Tyrone Watson.
Smooth. Two dribbles. Right to the basket. Nice touch. Whew, tough to stop that kind of size.
Averaging 15.1 points per game. 5.6 rebounds, Watson is. Here's Poole. He's wide open. And that's going to be Halifax ball. Yeah. That was Haywood.
And what,
deflected it off of Thomas.
Look at the rotation on that ball. You can see it on your TV screen. Perfect rotation. It's always got a chance if the ball's up high enough and coming down on the rim with perfect rotation. And they were arguing about an out-of-bounds call, which, you know, might have been knocked out of bounds, but.
Here's Washington trying to back down Baines.
Oh,
that was Jahid Carson that came out of nowhere.
Wow. Man, 5'10", timed it perfectly. He can get up. He's throwing down some crazy dunks and warm. Watch this. Look at that jump.
Wow.
Oh, boy.
Great athleticism right there. Great awareness defensively from Jahid Carson. Yeah.
Basketball fans watching that love that kind of play.
Pool. 2 seconds on the shot clock, and things run out for Halifax. As you see, Jahid Carson getting some instructions from head coach Joe Salerno. Mentioned that Halifax 5-5 in their last 10. Island Storm also 5-5 in their last 10. Keem Ellis. Here's Baines. Baines, Mason can't control him. And Baines having a night here so far.
Yeah. And usually most players start from inside out, and Baines started to hit his shots from outside, and then the inside opens up for him.
So Zitlinski gets tagged with the foul. So 5:45 remaining here in the second quarter. We're going to take a break, folks. It's the Storm by four over the Halifax Hurricanes.
Senor Caboto, on deck, sir. You won't believe your eyes.
Captain, over here. You must see this.
Look, Captain, down there.
I've never seen anything like it in my life.
Yeah. Amazing.
They stayed the progress of our ship. Your fleets have no further need of Iceland. Fish is enough to feed this kingdom. Oh, sire, until the end of time.
Island Storm Basketball on 5TV1 is brought to you by Centennial Auto Group, official vehicle provider of the Island Storm, one family, one customer at a time, since 1979. Peter Ruckgazer, Gord McNeely, and the 5TV1 crew. 5:45 remaining in the second quarter, and the Island Storm, they have themselves a 39-35 lead. See Akeem Ellis, he's hit a couple of deep threes. Terry Thomas has been on his game, and Jahid Carson, you just saw the fantastic defensive play he made, so things looking pretty good here so far in this one. Some things rotationally, as you said, they want to work on defensively. They need to get in order.
Yeah, and they did do that a little bit. They made a couple subs to Halifax team with their size and their speed at the guards. They run that pick on the for the one. It's usually a four or five player comes out, and they separate from each other so fast. It puts so much pressure on the defense, and that's what the Storm was having trouble with. They were giving up the three and the inside stuff. So here it is here, right there. See how they defend it? A little bit better. Good. Yeah, so forced a turnover.
And there's Dixon, comes into the game, gets his first taste of action, threw that ball away. Again, a little miscommunication. One thing that Coach Leslie said, executing in the half court offensively, that's something he wants to improve upon the next couple of weeks with the playoffs just around the corner.
And you can tell they're working on it, too.
Here's Terry Thomas. Misses that shot. Hasn't missed too many shots here so far in this one.
And you've seen Robin Norman into the game, too. That's what he's doing. He's in there for defensive purposes. They know they're getting a lot offensively. They really need to clean up their defense. And Norman's in there to shake that happen.
And that ball gets deflected out of bounds. There you see Mr. Norman. Great player for Dalhousie.
And he knows his role on this team. That's what it is. And guys like him are great to have in playoffs where he's working. He's always got his head on a swivel.
He was fantastic a couple of weeks ago in that game against London in limited minutes. Did a great job against some of the bigs with London.
Yeah, great camera work there. And you see him block out hard. He blocked out hard. His other player comes in, sweeps in, and gets the rebound. That's the importance of defense, folks. And for the young kids out there watching, learn how to play defense first. Forces Halifax to take a timeout.
So Halifax will talk things over. Terry Thomas, see him heading to the bench, get a breather. He's got 11 points, 5 of 7 from the field for Terry Thomas. And Akeem Ellis also having a good start to this one. 11 points, 4 of 7. And Terrell Baines got that hot hand, 10 points, 5 of 8 from the field. So some good contributions offensively from those players for the Island Storm.
You see a highlight pack there. They hit the three. They hit. You just saw Halifax hitting inside and then outside. Terry Thomas is going in one direction. That's right at you. And he does that very well. Ball's moving. Look at the footwork. Just gets it off and hopes it goes in. He's looking to draw that foul. And that's what you were talking about just now. Baines hitting that outside jump shot.
There it is again from the corner. And there's Akeem Ellis from another three-point shot from the bridge.
And that's good camera work. You saw the camera had to follow that ball. It was so high in the air. Ooh, what a
and
block.
And there's the Jahi Carson. Great block there. Terry Thomas, how do you play this guy? I mean, if you get too close to him, he's going to burn you. If you lay off him a little bit, he can shoot the outside shot. I mean, what's in the mind of a defender when you go up against 13?
You got to make sure that he catches it as a position that he doesn't want the ball. So that means that you have to deny him a little bit more. Then when he catches it, you have to square. You can't play him to drive to a certain left or right. You have to get your feet out wide and try to make him go, instead of going in a straight line, make him go in a kind of a U shape or side shape.
I would say Linsky. His shot didn't go. He's getting some action here. Here's Poole, fadeaway Jay. And Zaglinski brings down the rebound. He'll push it up the court. Defers here for Carson, a jumper off the iron.
He hasn't got many shots tonight, so. Yeah, he's one for three, one for four there now. Oh, good hands.
Great defensive play there by Terry Thomas.
Because that pass was open if Terry Thomas didn't get to that ball.
Nortman inside. Terry Thomas. Wow.
Wow, is right because he just wanted the basketball.
He wanted it more, yeah.
And I was looking at that play. I said, no, Robert Norman, don't pass the ball. He did. And then Terry Thomas just went after. It was an open ball.
Dixon, the Toronto native, drives. And they're going to call Ronaldo Dixon with the travel. Dixon out of New Mexico State, as you see Akeem Ellis.
Oh, man, and that was great help by Akeem Ellis, Peter. It was, and that's why you see Billy White coming back in. When Billy White's on the floor, you don't see that kind of help because no Billy White's person can't go over and help. But wow, good defense by Akeem Ellis.
41-35 Storm. 3:29 remaining in this first half.
Oh, boy.
Jahi Carson, he's going to drive. Boy, he was standing still and boom, just like that, he was off to the races.
Yeah, he was. That was a NASA rocket right there. Just skilled basketball play.
43-35, and the speed, you know.
Oh, they're sending a double. So watch this, see what happens out of this.
Billy White gets out of that double team. Here's Antoine Mason. And that rebound brought down by Terry Thomas. Whips the pass over here for Zieglinski.
And Joe Salerno was excited. I could tell that that was by design when he cut the ball because he was pretty pumped.
Oh, nice play by Zieglinski. And they waved the bucket off by Nortman. But it's a foul against Halifax.
And this Storm team is really playing together. And I can tell that they're listening to the advice and the things Joe Salerno is telling them, and they're really buying in because they've made a few defensive adjustments that I haven't seen them make thus far in the season, and they're working. So keep listening to your coach, fellas, if you're watching this on the replay.
And some good minutes there from Sam Zieglinski. As I mentioned, he played here with the Storm for Joe Salerno a couple of years ago, so you can really tell that he's comfortable with this Island Storm system and what Joe Salerno has to offer here.
When you have such good shooters, he's a good guy to have on there. It's going to bring in some good defense, knows the game, going to get the ball to who needs it. So he's a good playoff addition, I think, for the Storm.
Drive here by Watson. Oh, nice defensive play by Nortman as he gets the block, and he is pumped up. Wow, Robert Nortman. Oh. Getting up there.
Yeah, they were burned. Came back in the play and said,
wow.
Ooh, he's pumped. He's jacked up.
And that got A.J. Stewart. He's in civvies here because of that foot injury. That got A.J. off the bench and pumped up himself.
Well, it's defense. Defense is the name of the game in this league. You give up a lot. And then as you get close to the playoffs, that's got to shrink. You got to keep teams under 100 points. So
timeout call. And Mike Leslie, none too pleased. And a little bit of confusion from the Storm bench. I'm not too sure why.
I think they were talking about who called the timeout. Because there's only probably so many. So Salerno's talking to Mike Leslie. And these two guys know each other very well. Leslie coached under Joe Salerno here for a number of years and has done amazing things with basketball PEI. So to see him doing so well with this great Halifax team. Hey, Halifax, you got a great coach in Mike Leslie.
Definitely. And, you know, not today, but I think the last time that they came out here, I had a chance to sit down and talk to Mike Leslie. And he said that Joe Salerno taught him a lot about, you know, the things away from the court, the business side of professional basketball. So he credits Joe Salerno with teaching him a little bit about, you know, contracts and salary cap and running a team off the court.
Yeah. So, I mean, this Halifax team is well positioned. I'd like to see that they're hot and cold tonight. I see them play well in spurts and then not so well in other spurts. So I'm looking for their identity, their playoff identity to come through. You can see that the big people, Anthony Cox, Billy White, CJ Washington, they brought a lot of energy. You got to see it from your threes, twos, and then at the one position needs to be a little bit crisper.
So 2:23 remaining in the second quarter, 44-35 lead for the Storm. Both these teams played last night, so we're going to see how the legs feel come fourth quarter.
Mm-hmm. And the Storm's defensive adjustments have led to this 9-point lead. I think Halifax was a little bit stunned because that's why you saw, Peter, the last 4 or 5 minutes, you see a lot of timeouts. Halifax is like they're trying to make adjustments to the Storm's adjustments. So I love the chess match to basketball. You can learn so much just by watching and listening. So 2 minutes left to go here in this first.
Storm want to finish this first half out. Playing some good ball here. Try to increase that lead. Here's Terry Thomas trying to do just that, and he does. Terry Thomas shooting the ball very well here this evening.
Yeah, and the scouting report does not say that. It says keep him away from the his driving lanes, and when he's hitting that, which he can, very difficult night.
Yeah, we just talked about that, how you defend Agent 13, and that goes off the window. And that was Clink Scales.
Yeah, and a great take. We talked about this too before, Peter, like when your big people are scoring, I need more from the point guard position from that Halifax team, and that's exactly what Clint Scales did right there. It got to be an 11-point game. He took it to himself to penetrate and create. That's what good point guards do.
10-year pro out of DePaul. Extensive experience in the NBA D League. And he converts in the three-point play, 46-38 now.
Got a mismatch here. G. Carson versus Billy White. They're not going to go back to it.
Nortman trying to provide a screen. Ellis, another deep three. Boy.
And I can see Mike Leslie looking for the player. He's looking down to see. He's seeing who made the mistake there. And I don't know. When a player's shooting that well.
Another long three from Akeem Ellis. 49-38. Storm finishing out this quarter pretty good. Watson having some problems on the double team. And I'm not too sure. Is that a foul against Tyrone Watson? He's kind of confused.
No, it was a three-second.
Oh, okay.
Oh, funny because he looked down at his feet where he was. He moved where he was and where he was telling the ref about 3 feet out. So he's like, I'm right here. Oh, that's funny.
So under a minute here, 51-38. This is a nice, comfortable lead for the Storm.
Big mismatch inside now. Jahi Carson trying to guard Billy White.
Clint Scales hitting it from deep. Mm. And that's what Coach Leslie wanted from Clint Scales. Shoot the ball. Be a little bit more selfish with the ball. Thomas can't get it to go. Clint Scales slows it down, trying to set things up here.
He's a confident young point guard. He's going to log big minutes in playoffs.
And it's a foul on Jahi Carson. So Carson is going to come out. And Al Stewart will check in with 9.9 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Yeah, just to guard Clint Scales there and maybe make sure that G. Carson doesn't pick up a second foul.
So timeout called here. Overall, this second quarter, much better defensively, the Storm, would you say?
Great, really great adjustments they made there off the bringing in different subs, trusting guys. You see their hands got a little bit quicker. So amazing adjustments the Storm's made.
And here's some plays from Terry Thomas. And he's on his game here this evening.
See how fast he cut the ball and decided where he was going to go? And it's up to the defense to react. Same thing. Puts it on the floor. He's going in a straight line right to the basket. Here, watch this again. It's not there that time. Where's my other straight line on the other side? Just fantastic. I wish more kids would play like that. You know, lately it's gotten more razzle-dazzle and the crossovers in front. Terry doesn't cross you over or go between the legs as much. He's going in straight lines because he's a three. He's about 6'7", and that's what you have to do. You have to learn that first, and then you can get the razzle-dazzle between the legs, shimmy shake and all that stuff
right.
The Toronto Raptors announcers talk about. I mean, you got to learn that game first right there, and Terry Thomas does it as good as anybody in this country.
So right now, you got Terry Thomas with 17 points.
Holy cow.
8 of 11 from the field. So he's on his way to having a big evening here for the Island Storm.
And you think about those stats. Listen, there's 10 seconds left in the first half. He's putting so much pressure on Halifax.
In terms of the rebound battle, it has not been good so far for the Storm. As Halifax out-rebounding the Storm 29-16. So despite that, It is a 10-point lead, and that's got to be something that Coach Salerno is going to have to pay attention to in the second half.
He'll see those stats, and he'll be like, So you got to control the point guard play here. They got fouls to give, so that's why they took Jahi Carson out, because they know that Al
don't want him to be taking fouls. Yeah,
they might see that again.
Billy White.
Oh my goodness!
Spin move by White, and Akeem Ellis will get called for the foul.
At 6'10" almost, you're not supposed to be able to do that. That was a watch this crazy spin, and good help by Richter.
So there again is the situation where he's such a matchup problem for your basketball team. Billy White is.
Yeah, and he's catching that ball on the 3-point line and doing that. So I didn't see that in his repertoire, that quick whirl. So it's, you got tons of time, and G. Carson's going to come back in again to push the ball down the floor. 6 seconds left, lots of time to get a quality shot here. And it's timeout will advance it to center. Or maybe it's, just a sub.
So he's going to take Al Richter out and bring Jahi into the game. 5.7 seconds remaining.
Watch the speed here.
In a second.
There it goes.
And Antoine Mason bumps Carson.
And they got fouls to give too. So that's his second. You don't want him to get doing that too many times.
Keem Ellis trying to get this ball up. And great play there by Akeem Ellis. Missed the shot, but eluded the long reach of Billy White. So, there you go, 51-43. I think if you told the Island Storm they'd have a lead like this against the top team in the Atlantic Division, they would take it.
Certainly would.
So there you see it, 51-43, Storm leading Halifax. We're stepping out. We're coming back with our halftime report right after this on 5TV1.
What's in my hockey stick? Mine's full of fun and exploding with exercise. It's stuffed with self-confidence, packed with practice makes perfect, and loaded with leadership. I keep it taped together with teamwork. I think it's made of carbon fiber, though.
Give them the chance to discover what their equipment is made of. Give them the chance to play. Visit sportnovascotia.ca to find out how you can help.
Being part of an Easter Seals camp has really shaped who I am today. My dream is to see every kid in Canada living with a disability go to an Easter Seals camp so they can experience what I have experienced. See ability in disability. See the difference? Be the difference.
Text Easter to 45678. Make your $10 donation today.
Pedal bike. Just imagine pedaling your bike every day, going the carpoon to Lancer Meadows. We've been all over the place here. We went in every nook and cranny and climbed across the roof and hung on the beam. You know what young fellas like. When this is here, you come and explore. My character is Ragnar. And my role is a blacksmith. Talk about where the Vikings got their iron. and smelt it down and turn it into nails. The Vikings.
Yeah, I think they're still here.
Welcome back, everybody. At the half, the Island Storm, they have themselves a 51-43 lead against the Halifax Hurricanes. Time now for the 5TV1 Plays of the Week.
Chris.
Jaden Pope is just robbed. Stead back and scores! What a touch there by Stead! It looks like the Falcons were getting it out.
Out. And that means the Wards are going to have to.
Here's the shot from Tucker. Rebound! Scores! Puck was deflected in front of the net. Off the stick of Tucker. Be our guest. Be our guest. The Falcon service passed the test in, Chris. And they're back into it. It's 2-1. Ranson. Steps up, leaves it for Colin Guest. Guest attacks the blue line. Kevin drives to the net. Across there, scores!
Now that was a real nice goal by Kevin Guest.
My goodness, just like that, with two in a row on the same shift, the Guest brothers have put their stamp on this game.
He's gonna pick that one up.
Player all alone in front, throws down, scores! It's Smith, all alone in front of the net. And with 3:18 left to go, the Wolverines take the lead. 10 seconds remain. Falcon, final rush. Puck chipped to the neutral zone. Out to the line. That's going to do it. Your 2017 champions for PWA are going to be the RBC Falcons. Congratulations. Coach Dave Murray, Justin Parsons. Can't happen to any two nicer guys, Chris.
There you go. They've been around this game for a while, put a lot of time and effort into it.
And a tip of our hat to the Falcons. What a tournament they had.
Wouldn't it be nice to have a big brother?
So what you want to do this weekend?
I want to go to the Canada Game Center. I want to go swimming on the big yellow slide, which goes outside.
Yeah, that would be fun.
Yeah.
Definitely do that for sure.
Yeah.
Probably go bowling, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kids with mentors grow up to be more successful adults. Supporting Big Brothers Big Sisters is a great way to have a positive impact on your community. To volunteer or make a donation, go to bigbrothersbigsisters.ca.
Sorry.
Thank you.
kilometers off the beaten path. And then there's this place. Newfoundland and Labrador.
Is that 5TV?
Oh, you know it, man.
With ultra-stunning 4K picture quality.
I love using Restart.
I use that all the time.
We love having Crave TV and Netflix right on it.
And having all my TVs set up wirelessly, it's amazing.
Can you imagine some people still don't have 5TV?
I don't have it. Because I was living abroad.
With so many reasons to love 5TV, it's time to make the switch to the best TV service.
Oh, sorry.
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 Sorry. Sorry. Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry. Sorry.
Sorry.
That's wonderful. Thank you very much. Oh, boy. Thank you.
You make me feel so young.
Think young. Pass it on.
You make me feel so spring has sprung.
Out on the roads or sending the kids off to school, having an accurate weather forecast is important.
It's a classic nor'easter, in fact.
No one takes the signs of weather more seriously than CTV Atlantic's chief meteorologist, Cindy Day.
Chilly temperatures on the way, Steve.
Cindy's comprehensive forecast and most accurate outlook will prepare you for what's ahead on TV, online, and in your community. Find out first with Cindy Day, the meteorologist more Maritimers trust.
Happy birthday!
That's wonderful. Thank you, dear Bernie.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel so spring has sprung. And every time I see
you, you're not fooling anybody, you know. Think young. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
What's in my hockey stick? Mine's full of fun and exploding with exercise. It's stuffed with self-confidence, packed with practice makes perfect, and loaded with leadership. I keep it taped together with teamwork. I think it's made of carbon fiber, though.
Give them the chance to discover what their equipment is made of. Give them the chance to play. Visit sportnovascotia.ca to find out how you can help.
It's packed to the rafters in the Edmonton Arena. Everyone is feeling the pressure on the grabs as they await the American champs. Here's the Cleveland favorite Knits now, and boy, do they look impressive.
Look at their uniforms.
I bet you could sure run in smart shorts like those.
Not that. Look, world champs in my eye.
Grats. We don't play for glory. We play the game for the game's sake. So tonight, you're going to earn that title by playing your game. Teamwork, passing. Let's show them what it means to play the Grats.
Champions for 25 years. The record of 502 wins and only 20 losses is unmatched in all of sport.
Welcome back, everybody. Island Storm Basketball on 5TV1 brought to you by Insight Brand and Marketing Studio. Experience Insight. Peter Ruckgazer alongside Gord McNeely and the 5TV1 crew, and the score as we get ready for third quarter action, 51-43 in favor of the Storm. Storm trying to win just their second game against this Halifax team in eight tries, or excuse me, this is nine tries now. And your assessment of that first half, Gord?
Well, it was a good half by both teams. A good half by the Halifax team because you're on the road. Did they play well? No, not really. Did they show flashes? Oh, yeah. They're a really good team. So what team will you get in the third quarter? For the Storm, they needed to make some adjustments. They needed to listen to their head coach in that first into that second period of frame, and they did that very well. They're playing well individually, going to the basket and creating shots. Defensively, you got to still keep gang defending. And if they do that, they could extend this lead. But listen, this third quarter, it's a key. You didn't rebound the ball well for the Storm in the first half. If that doesn't change, this Halifax team is going to come roaring back.
Yeah, you talk about not rebounding the ball very well. Halifax just really taking it to the Storm in terms of rebounding. 30-16 in favor of Halifax, and that was a big concern going into this game for the Storm because this Halifax team, they're a lot bigger, and they have dominated the glass here this evening.
Yeah, and they're physical. They play physical. They're not just, if they're going to an offensive rebound, they're going to push the referees to make that call, and they're going to keep coming at you until the refs call that. So they get a lot of rebounds, and the Storm haven't had as many opportunities in the offensive glass. But listen, when Terrell Baines is hitting 20-footers, 18-footers, Akeem Ellis is your other post player. He's hitting 30-footers. I mean, the ball went the right way for the Storm in the first half. But listen, you cannot let up with this Halifax team. This is a big, big, big game for them because, listen, the Storm team goes to Cape Breton at 7 in the morning tomorrow morning.
Right.
And then they don't come back for, like, weeks. You know, they're going to Ontario right from there. So this is a big, big game for them.
Storm shot 47.8% in that first half. Halifax shot 40.5%. And then from three-point range, 35.7% in favor of the Island Storm on 5 of 14 from downtown. And 2 of 6 for Halifax from three-point land for 33.3%. So the Storm shooting the ball very well. Just not getting it done in terms of rebounding. They protected the ball very well. They've only turned the ball over 3 times compared to 14 times for Halifax. So overall, I would think that head coach Joe Salerno is happy, but
yeah,
this team here in Halifax, they've got all kinds of depth, and they can turn it on in the drop of a hat. So we'll see what takes place here as we get set for this third quarter. A 51-43 lead for the Storm. Trying to knock off 2 real big teams in this league. They won last night against St. John, trying to do it against Halifax here this evening.
Yeah, here comes a double screen right away. They're going to say, hey, this is our game right here. Nobody switches. Everybody stays with their player.
Mason, that's a tough shot. Air ball.
Oh.
Clink Scale's going to drive. And off the glass and in.
Dahee Carson was hobbling there. He came up favoring that left ankle.
Yeah, he doesn't seems to be okay. Just a little tweak there, maybe. Have to watch for that
just
here.
Just step right there. Good camera work.
They Terry Thomas. Wow. Nice shot there by Agent 13. Clink Scale swings it over. A little out of the reach of Antoine Mason.
Yeah, so quick turnover, but I'm just watching Jahee Carson. His ankle seems to be okay. Great cam work there. We saw him just step on the foot of C.J. Washington. Everything's great.
Wide open is Carson and gets the tray.
And that's the best way to get over a little bummed ankle. Let's hit a 3.
Storm by 10. Drive here. That's Clink Scales, so he's doing exactly what Mike Leslie has asked him to do, score a little bit more. Jahee Carson trying to put up the circus shot. Didn't work.
Yeah, here's good touch he's got. Oh, twice they've thrown that ball.
And Clink Scales trying to go cross court there a couple of times, not being able to hook up with the receiver.
Yeah, and Mike Leslie gives a sign like you're trying to shut a suitcase, you know. Just settle down, everybody.
Baines, Mike Ritger. That hits the iron.
Yeah, and he had Washington closing out on him. That's why he rushed it a little bit. Washington, good defender.
Clink Scales, there you go. He's feeling it.
Yeah, he gave the bunny hop after that. That means, yeah, you know, you're starting to feel it. So you got a problem there. Your point guard's starting to get hot for Halifax. If you're the Storm, that's a big problem.
Baines, that rimmed out. Boy, in a blink of an eye, they've cut this lead down to 5, Halifax. It was a 10-point lead, 9:53 remaining in the third quarter. So they've cut into that lead very fast. C.J. Washington, he'll send it out here to Mason. Mason wants to drive. Mason, nice little shot there. Nice little touch by Antoine Mason.
Such good touch. It was just, he leapt, he saw the defender, brought it down, and just softly put it up on the rim. Just a nice play.
Son of the late New York Knick, Anthony Mason.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I used to watch Mace a lot.
A little bit of a different player than his dad. Here comes Halifax the other way, and an easy lay-in for Tyrone Watson.
Yeah, Joe Salerno's walking, doing the walk, like the timeout or not walk.
Yeah.
So he's just going to let them play here, one-point game. And they said, if you do not come out, this eight-point lead with this Halifax team is nothing. You got to come out and play hard, hard, hard. And they just, it's a little bit sloppy for the Storm.
They had themselves a 10-point lead here in this third quarter, and now it's a one-point lead. That pass intercepted by Jahee Carson. It goes to Terry Thomas. Ritger's going to try Trey.
Oh, what a
and
rebound.
That was no good.
Clint Scales held off two guys to get that rebound.
Here's Mason from downtown. He can't sink it. Jahee Carson. He got stripped of the ball. Antoine Mason back the other way. Mason off the window and in.
Touch, 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 touch.
And boy, oh boy.
He wants a foul,
yeah,
on that.
Yeah, he wanted a foul. So did Mike Leslie. Not going to get it. Wow. Just like that, in the blink of an eye, this Halifax team cut in the lead. Yeah, see, is there a foul here?
Yeah, there's a foul there because the defender's moving in a funny direction. He's got one hand up trying to show the ref he's moving away, but still making contact with his hip. And underneath his armpit in that area, he's still making contact. That's a foul every time. Just because you turn away and pretend you're not looking, okay, you're going to pick up that foul. And it wasn't Akeem Ellis' fault. It's because you're getting bad shots on the other end and turnovers, and then Halifax is coming out and fast breaking you. So that's why you're on a 9-0 run.
Okay, so 8:16 remaining in the third. 56-55 in favor of Halifax. Back to Charlottetown in just a second.
Being part of an Easter Seals camp has really shaped who I am today. My dream is to see every kid in Canada living with a disability go to an Easter Seals camp so they can experience what I have experienced. See ability in disability. See the difference? Be the difference.
Text Easter to 45678. Make your $10 donation today.
Welcome back, everybody, to Charlottetown. 8:08 remaining in the third quarter. And Halifax, they've come on strong here to begin this third quarter. And they now have themselves a one-point lead.
Yeah, and Al Stewart's in. It's a nice sub for him. Allison's in, too, as well, and as well as Wack in for the Storm.
Tyrone Watson spins. And a foul against Mike Allison.
And that's just the tenacity of Halifax offensive rebounding. You know, they're coming at you. You'll see it here. Mike Allison's on the left. So he tries to hit one. He gets slipped underneath. See that position that he got? Instead of Mike Allison needed to take his right foot and step hard, he just let the player come in and gets better positioning, and you're going to get a foul.
So a little delay here as Clink Scales will inbound the ball. Gets it to C.J. Washington. Back to Clink Scales. Nice pass. And that was great execution, offensive execution right there from Halifax. Mike Leslie happy with that.
Yeah, so many good things on that one play. Just dribbler froze the defensive player. The roller went to the right spot. Tough to defend that. So. And you can see how Halifax just came in and said, no, we're going to dominate this quarter. And I said the third quarter is going to be huge. You can't allow that to happen. So keep setting the tone. Don't rely on your shooting and just do the little things.
Three-point lead for Halifax here. Al Stewart. Can't make that shot. Loose ball. And Mike Allison does a great job of saving it. Ellis to Terry Thomas. Great hustle there by the Island Storm.
And their broken play. They needed that so badly for something good to happen.
Clink Scales. A little too strong. Thomas will push it. Al Stewart bobbled it, recovered. Swings it over for Ellis. Whack, back to Ellis again. The fake and the drive, yes! Gets the hoop and the harm.
He's fired up, he's asking his loyal soldier fans to get up with me. Nice take, a beautiful shot fake, ball fake, put it on the floor twice. Again, if you're a player out there, you don't want to put it on the floor more than twice. Watch, once, twice, and then you're two steps in, into the body, flip it over the front. Easy game.
Well, not really an easy game.
No, it's not. He just makes it look easy.
Yeah, there's some guys here in this league, they do make basketball look very easy, yeah. And Akeem Ellis is one of them.
And they're in a zone.
There's Billy White. Allison comes in with a block. And they got to call out a goaltend?
Well, they called it like about 22 seconds late.
And there's Mike Allison trying to talk to the referee. Yeah. Disagrees. Joe Salerno disagrees.
And it was a goaltend. We might see it again later on. But
it was a late call. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, it was a late call. So that's just frustrating. It's another reason coaches can get on referees.
Whack with the jumper.
You'd rather have the ref call it than not.
Make the decisive call right away. Bounce pass inside for Washington. And they wave off the bucket.
And a good job of gang rebounding. Terry Thomas took that offensive foul. Billy White's, and you see, that's the difference when you keep people out. They have to go over your back, and that's going to bring Billy White out of the game, which will allow the Storm to maybe potentially go on another run. He's that good a player.
Billy White has to come out of the game. He's very frustrated. Had an animated conversation there with Clink Scales, and so he'll go to the bench and cool off a bit. Tied at 60, turnover by the Storm, or turnover by Halifax. And now Clink Scales will set it up. Antoine Mason, the jumper, he adjusted there in midair. Brought down by Watson, and they'll try it all over again.
Well, that's a good offensive rebound.
The alley and the oop as C.J. Watson takes that pass from Clink Scales.
And he did about four amazing things in the last 40 seconds of basketball there to get his team a basket.
Hurricanes by two. Whack, mid-range jumper, no good. And Mike Allison got his hands on it, but knocked it out of bounds. So now Brad States will come in for a change of pace as Akeem Ellis
a nice little pass.
Take a seat.
Yeah, that's a nice little pass and finish. He put some spin on it. He's on the left side of the court, finished with his right hand. A little bit of spin on that ball. Perfect.
Clink Scales averaging 7.3 assists a game. So he knows how to set the table. And there's Anthony Cox.
He might have hurt his ankle, too.
Yeah, he's limping a bit. Terry Thomas. And misses that shot as he drove in there, and he's getting up slowly, and that's always a concern when you see that with Terry Thomas. He's had that lower body problem all season long.
And Mike Allison's frustrated. Mike Allison, new player for the Storm, number two. He's been a step slow on certain plays, and it's because of the physicality. He's got to get down and hit this person right there. Do you know what I mean? And he's got to hit it, and he's got to set a tone and let everybody know that I'm the man down in here, so nobody else come in here. He's almost 6'10".
Here's Cox. Allison trying to work on him. Spin move. Oh, wow.
That's what we talked about, and that's what happens. If you don't set the right tone, okay, players will come back and remember that, and Cox just went right after him.
Cox and Billy White have really had his number here this evening. Here's Allison trying to reply offensively and can't. Clink scales now. Inside for C.J. Watson, and Brad Stage takes the foul.
Yeah, and Allison's going to come out because I was watching that play. And it's unfortunate. Basketball's cruel, right? It's just this is Brad State's coming over to help an Allison's person who was down on the other end, and Allison's going to sit a break. But you get behind on one play, and if you get arguing with the referees or you get doing this, you get behind in the whole game. And that's what happened to Mike Allison there for the past five or six possessions. It just was one step too slow.
So C.J. Washington at the line. Man, you take a look at this Halifax lineup. You got a lot of guys in double averaging double digits in scoring. Mm-hmm. Here's one of them. In the case of C.J. Washington, averaging 14.7 points.
And you know what's funny, Peter, is that we just said, oh, it was 60-60, and Billy White went out of the game. And now it's 68-60.
Yeah.
So the Storm have not taken advantage of that whatsoever. And it's kind of frustrating as an Island Storm fan. There you go.
There's Al Stewart turning the corner. Can't finish, though. So yeah, it has to be frustrating because there's a matchup nightmare for you out of the game. But at the same time, as Washington scores, you've got Washington, you've got Cox. I mean, there's so much depth.
Yeah, there's a 10-point run, and Halifax has their best player on the sidelines there. So you're looking at a third quarter. We talked about how important this third quarter was. The Storm are losing this third quarter by 20 points. Pretty near 20 points. I mean, get it together and do it defensively. You can't allow deep post position like that.
Turnaround shot there by Cox. Talk about making it look easy.
Yeah, it's a toughness thing. This game is going to be one on toughness. Halifax came out, and they're a tough team. They're a good team. You got to answer.
There is Al Stewart. He gets fouled. So it's a 10-point lead now. At one point in the third quarter, it was a 10-point lead for the Storm, as you mentioned. And, wow, they've really turned it around. So now Joe Salerno wants to change of pace, so he's going to bring in Zielinski.
And it's just quality of shots, and it's just a different team. Hey, this is you're at home right now. Halifax has turned the momentum. You got to turn it back. And you're going to do that by just being as aggressive on defense as you possibly can.
Al Stewart making the first of two. The only time this season that the Storm have won a game against this Halifax team back on March the 19th, a game that we broadcasted right here on 5TV1, 112-103. And a foul there on Cox, and he'll head to the line.
Yeah, and this is not how you do it. A simple screen at the ball. You've got to figure out and talk to that guy. You know it's coming. Watch, here it is, and it's just Brad States is guarding somebody on the other side of the court, and he's got to come over and make the play. So, I mean, you can't have that. It's just breakdowns. These are the things you work on in playoffs. When Salerno talks about it, you got to make sure that you're playing it exactly the way he wants it done.
Cox misses the first of two.
And, Peter, it's no fun for a point guard to sit there and be hammered. Some guy, 6'10", 6'9", come in and say hello right in the side of your head. But that's playoffs. It's getting you ready.
And Cox makes the second shot. Now the Storm going to make some adjustments here. As Stewart and States come out, Nortman and Jahi Carson will come in.
Not surprised they're coming in for Norman, because he's the toughest guy on the team right now. He's the guy that should be playing, in my mind, 30 minutes, because he's tough. He's tough in there. So hopefully he'll come on and set a tone here and stop this 20-point swing in this basketball game.
Zetlinski, Jahi Carson, 7 on the shot clock. He's going to drive, and he gets the hoop and the harm. So maybe that'll get the Storm rolling a little bit here.
And Peter, why did that go in? It came in because Norman came out and said this crazy screen for Jahi Carson's person. Okay, and took him out. Watch this. There's a screen. And then it frees him. Well, I wouldn't say there was much room there. Jahi Carson just made a crazy play.
Right.
But he set the tone with the screen. And that's what Halifax has been doing to the Storm this third quarter.
73-67. Late stages of the third quarter here in Charlottetown. Poole.
There we go. They fought through it there.
Poole. Oh, nice jumper by Mike Poole.
And that was just a good player. I mean, there was nothing there. The Storm took actually the thing they were supposed to take away. Mike Poole found an open space and then stuck this J, but he's a good player. Mike Poole, I always like him. He's just smooth and accurate.
Loose ball. There's Baines. Nortman has it. He can't hang on. Zimmerman, the pool. Oh, nice touch pass there. Antoine Mason gets it over for C.J. Washington. And, boy, they really share that ball, this Halifax team. Mm.
Just a great team playing right there. Off a turnover, too, right? So Nortman grabbed the rebound. Should have just gone right back up with it, which this created a fast break opportunity. And just that's what Halifax has been doing to teams all season long.
You talked about Poole. Here's another example of the depth that they have on this team. This is a guy averaging 12 points a game, doesn't get big minutes. He gets a fair share of minutes, and he's shooting 40% from the field. So they've got a lot of those guys in their lineup.
Oh, yeah, and he's just so versatile.
Nortman bobbled it, gets it back again, bobbled it again as Anthony Cox was all over him.
And we're struggling to find that offensive solution. And Zielinski passed it to Robert Nortman with the shot clock going down. Well, Nortman doesn't really want to shoot the ball. That's not what he's there for. So if you're going to pass the ball to him, pass it, go get it, and then create something. You're the guard. One or two guards have to create, especially when you're down 10 here in the third quarter.
Storm trying to finish up strong here to end this third. Oh, that was a nifty pass right there by Zielinski. Wow. Got it over to Baines, and Baines, that's his office over there in the corner. He's done that several times here this evening.
Yeah, and that's a huge shot for them right now. They need a defensive stop here, two or three defensive stops here with 1 minute left and a score on the other end to get themselves close.
Halifax by 8. Under a minute now in this third quarter. There's a shot by C.J. Washington, and Zielinski goes for a tumble. It's going to be Halifax ball.
But is the shot clock reset? Did he have possession? Watch this. He just got off balance. Nobody kind of touched him.
And then he knocked it out of bounds.
So that kind of hurts, because you did everything you needed to do. And now the other team is going to get it back for another 24.
See if the Storm. Oh,
look at that offensive play.
Wow. Was that a push in the back there, though, on Richter?
It could have been. But listen, Richter, you should know what's coming. This Halifax team is going to push you, hit you.
Kicked out for Richter. He's going to drive. Zielinski fakes the shot. Going to try it in the corner. Off the iron. Brought down by Poole.
I'd like to see Zielinski shoot that first one. He's got a nice shot. Nice release. Just fire that up. We believe in that shot you're going to throw up.
13 seconds remaining now.
When you were mentioning, was that a push in the back? I mean, it's the physicality wins these wars, right?
Oh, that was CJ Washington tried the one-handed jam.
Oh, foul call. Oof.
So Washington will head to the line. So he's got a chance here to increase the 10-point lead. So it looked like the Storm were going to cut into that lead a little bit, and then boom, just like that, Halifax got it back up to 10 points.
A good challenge by Norman, and that's what he's saying. He's out of position because it's not even his guy. He's going over and making a play, and that's what Joe Salerno wants. He wants guys who are going to make plays, and you know, he could have gotten dunked on right there. He gave his body up, and he said, I'm going to challenge this guy.
C.J. Washington now with 24 points in this game, and he's got 10 rebounds, so he's had a big evening here for Halifax. Misses the second one, follows up. No block out there. And boy, not a great way to finish a quarter for the Island Storm as Halifax came on. So 82-69 after three quarters of play. Stepping out, coming back to Charlottetown right after this on 5TV1.
Oh, sorry.
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 Oh! Sorry.
Welcome back, everybody. Time now for the Alsko kiss off the glass. And here is Terry Thomas, takes that pass from Akeem Ellis. Little shovel pass right there from Akeem Ellis. And it all got started by Mike Allison saving that ball. So some good hustle by the Island Storm. And that is the Alsko kiss off the glass. And the Storm did not finish off that third quarter in very good style. Halifax came on, and they now have a nice, comfortable lead here. It's 82-69 in favor of this Halifax team. And Halifax, they played last night, played a depleted Cape Breton team, won that game going away 121-66. And last night, the Storm, they were in St. John, New Brunswick, to take on the Riptide. They won that game 104-92. So both these teams trying to extend two-game winning streaks. Right now, though, looks like Halifax is going to extend the winning streak. The Storm need to come out with a little bit more vigor here in the fourth quarter.
Well, they're, like we said, rebounding. The Storm, I'm kind of baffled at the rebounding numbers here. You know, like, you've got to make sure that you keep that going. It says that the Island Storm have 21 rebounds
compared to 48.
That's got to be a misprint. Wow. But you see what I mean? You can't win basketball games when you're losing the glass by this much. And the Halifax team is giving them a clinic on how to rebound and play the four and five positions. So it's just a gut check right here. It's a toughness check. And that's a good take going to the basket. Something aggressive. Terry Thomas didn't get enough looks in that third quarter. He needs to get going here in this fourth quarter and chip at this basketball game and win the rebounding match from here to the end of the game.
I mean, last night they were out rebounded 62-52 against St. John. That's acceptable. But right now they are just taking it on the chin in the rebounding category. And there's Al Richter. And that's got to change here in this fourth quarter.
Well, yeah, there's size, then there's things with rebounding. Size, effort, and determination. If it, the Storm need to get all three. Well, you can't do much about size, but determination and effort. Oh, the answer.
There's Mike Poole.
Wow.
Nice looking shot there from 10.
His hands are down. He knows it. He was looking for somebody to talk to.
Linsky's shot no good and brought down by Zimmerman. Here's Poole again. Directing traffic.
Yeah. See, that's what happens. Terry Thomas trying to fight through that screen. If it's an illegal screen and you're fighting through it, you're going to get the benefit of that call more often than not. So that's how you fight through that screen right there. You be physical, keep your feet moving, and you get through it.
85-72 lead for Halifax. Good ball movement. Ellis wants to go in on Washington. Off the window and in.
And they have to respect his shot. Little pump fake and go.
Got to get back on defense, and there's a foul right there. And Al Ritger will get tagged for that one. You know, we talked about this Halifax team. As you take a look at that nice drive there by Akeem Ellis, talk about this Halifax team, 5-5 in the last 10 games. In that sequence, they lost three games in a row, which is hard to believe when you consider what a great season this Halifax team has had. But I talked to Coach Leslie, and he said that his team, this is unbelievable, they had a break from March the 27th to April the 12th. They oh, wow. played no games, and coming out of that break, they were kind of stale. They had some good practices, he said, but nothing like having game action. And they came back a little out of sync, and they're trying to recover here and get ready for the postseason. And they're looking good here in this game, 85-74 lead.
Yeah, it's probably some curling event in there or something. In the,
yeah, that's strange, you know, yeah. Midway through the season to have that much time off. And
yeah.
They tried to cope with it.
And, you know, CJ Washington here probably enjoyed that break because he's having a monster game. I think he's got 7 points, 11 rebounds, 3 assists. So he's taken over this game.
Yeah, he's taken over for Billy White, who got in off to a great start but got into foul trouble. Billy White with 4 fouls, so he hasn't seen a lot of the court. And there's a big-time shot.
Big-time off the glass. See that screen?
That's a big screen right there by Cox on Zielinski.
I told you that was going to be a factor all night, that screen up top. Oh.
Harry Thomas.
Got a caught on his hip.
Lost it. And they're going to say that that is Halifax ball.
Wants to step in. And you need something good to happen when you're in a new program. You're nervous. Everything's going well. Nice release. And then the bank shot.
There you go. Nothing wrong with that.
But if you want to hit a bank shot, that's the best spot to do it. You know, shoot a little bit strong.
Didn't Tim Duncan make a career doing that?
Well,
hitting bank shots? Well, from there. Not from there, but.
Oh, he's up and down. He's traveling. But, yeah, use the glass. I used to practice that. Used to do 100 on one side, 100 on the next side,
yeah.
Just about 6-7 feet out. It starts you to get learning how to put some touch on the ball.
No, I wasn't trying to suggest that Tim Duncan was a great three-point shooter.
I think he could shoot it, though. I didn't watch the West much. I didn't watch Tim Duncan all that much. It was more East. I used to watch Anthony Mason play.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Boy, Antoine's dad was quite the beast when it came to rebounding and crashing the glass.
Oh, yeah. He was awesome.
There's another rebound there for Halifax.
His son competes just like him. He's got that edge to him. I like it.
Poole. Inside for Washington. And nice rebound there by Zielinski. He's going to drive it. Kicks it out. Ellis. Ritger for 3. No good.
Good transition. Good sequence of basketball there. But the Storm, when you've got your point guard at 6 foot rebounding the ball on the weak side, you got to get your big guys rebounding a little bit more.
And there's Zimmerman as he drains that one. So it's a 88-77 lead. Keem Ellis is going to try from downtown. Whoa. Man, wow. He's done that about three or four times.
He has.
Not just a three. I mean a three.
And that's going to give him 22 points in the game, man. That's a deep ball.
And for Akeem Ellis, I guess three of eight from three-point range.
I think that might have been
four.
Yeah,
four
we're just
nine,
waiting for an update.
Yeah, waiting for it to update here as you take a look. Wow.
And if you're going to shoot long range like that, make sure you get that rotation. The ball goes up in his hands, then it flicks. His wrist goes back, causing that backwards rotation. Perfect.
Yeah, they just refreshed the stats here. So 4 of 9 from three-point land for Akeem Ellis.
Yeah. And look at C.J. Washington with touch. He's having a great game.
Terry Thomas with the long bomb.
And that's good and everything, but how do you defend this screen? It's killing you. It's just killing you. See, here it is again. Watch how we defend it. Good. Better. Physical at top.
And then Poole, boy. Yeah,
because everybody's watching the screen. So once you've got one thing down, they're going to hit different options. So this is why Halifax team is a championship, going to be championship of the Atlantic side.
So Poole has been feeling it.
That's going to be three
and
shots,
there's
folks.
Three shots there. A foul on Ellis by C.J. Washington.
And Mr. Poole is not happy. Man, he's emotional. I love his emotion on the floor. But see if it's a foul. Well, that's Terry Thomas's three. Just went in. It's good for him to get it going. And then Akeem Ellis got fouled on the left side of the floor shooting a three. So
he's going to get three shots here.
And what's good about this is it gives you a chance to set your defense. So, again, listen, the Storm are back into a rut of not defending the screen well. So you've got your two players up top. Watch the body contact. But we won't see it because the ball is so high in the air. But good replay action. But now they're struggling to defend the ball, defend the four players who can score. Now the three players hitting the three. So everybody needs to do a gut check here with 7 minutes left to go to try to give this home. There is the contact right there. This is crazy good camera work. I think these camera crews are the best in the in the nation.
Got
here.
A good angle of it right there.
Yeah.
So Washington's going to come out. Billy White checks back in. He's been on the bench for quite some time. He's in foul trouble. He's got four fouls against him.
Yeah, he's going to look to get things going right away. He's sat for a while. He's probably itching to touch the ball here.
There's Poole. He loses it. That will be Halifax ball. Yeah, so Billy White had to spend some extended minutes on the bench, and picking up the slack for him was C.J. Washington, who now he's got four fouls against him. He has to sit for a bit. And C.J. Washington, 11 of 19 from the field, 27 points. And a very impressive night for number 20. Poole missed that one. Hadn't missed in a while. And now Wack will charge it up the court.
Oh my gosh.
Winging a prayer shot there by Rashad Wack.
Oh, they needed that, but wow. I could see him pick up his steps, and I was like, there's nowhere to go. And that's how you just get it up there at the basket, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. That time it was a very good shot.
93-87 for Halifax. And a foul, I think it's going to be against Akeem Ellis.
So there's no place to go. He picks up his dribble. The defender stops. His own player is there.
Oh, he changed hands there, didn't he, huh?
Yeah, he changed hands back to his right. Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was a tough shot.
So a big shot for them, for sure. They needed it to go. But you can see how the Hurricanes are scoring with more flow and continuity. And the Storm are more individual, three-point, getting to the line for 3 points, big three-point shot. So the Halifax is just doing it systematically, and that's why they're so good.
Akeem Ellis from deep again. No good. Watson skies to get that rebound.
And Halifax will come in. They'll run their stuff. They'll try to get the best shot possible. Very, very hard to compete with this team.
Here's Billy White. And that ball turned over by White. Good defense by the Storm. And now a lay-in for Terry Thomas.
And a good, good gut check to get themselves back in this basketball game.
Black 6-17.
Yeah.
6-17 remaining in this one. Billy White. Poole. White again. And oh. Allison with a foul.
And Allison's asking, he's telling the refs, they hooked me. Look at that steal there by Rashad Wack. Head up all the time, dribbling left hand. One dribble. That's all it takes for Terry Thomas. He's having a great game. Terry Thomas has really done some exceptional things tonight. Like 26 points, 12 for 18 from the floor.
That's not too shabby.
Two for two from three-point line. You know, that's they got to keep going to him with the 6 minutes left to go in this game to get them back and maybe taking the lead or get it to equality.
White at the line.
And it's, in my mind, he's probably the best post player in the league. Just the way he sets his screen. And that's the only problem he has. Like, if the referees and when they're on the road call him for being too aggressive, he's going to have to sit for a large period of time. But, I mean, he makes so much happen for so many players on his team.
Shahid Carson inside for, oh, there you go. Doing it defensively. And then sets up Watson. And no, can't get it to roll. And there's C.J. Washington to follow up. They wave it off the bucket. But there you see. Can do it at both ends of the court, Billy White.
And he's talking. He's telling him they're at center court. Watch gives him. See, oh, he got between a dunk and a layup. So, oh, that was a big play for the Storm right there to stay in this game.
So timeout call. We're gonna step aside. 97-89, Halifax in front of the Island Storm. Back with more in Charlottetown right after this commercial message.
Oh, sorry.
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 Storm Basketball on 5TV1 is presented to you by Shamrock Trust, a proud partner of the Island Storm with locations in Prince Edward Island, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, and Newfoundland. Peter Ruckgazer, Gord McNeely, the 5TV1 crew here in Charlottetown. 5:46 remaining in regulation, and Halifax with a 97-89 lead, and you're seeing the great diversity of this Halifax roster here this evening. They can do a bit of everything, and great example of that is Billy White getting the job done offensively in that last little sequence we saw, and then coming back and making a great stop there defensively. So what a diverse team that Mike Leslie has, and they're going to be a force come playoff time.
Oh, what, I mean, the Storm had a what looked like to be a dunk layup, and it turned into a fast break. You know, that's, and it's just amazing the skills of this Halifax team, how they work together, play together. You don't know where the shots are coming from. They're going to be a force in playoffs.
Jahi Carson with the J.
So is that guy. And he's had a relatively quiet night. He's got 9 points, 11 points on the game. So he can really get hot here to lead the Storm down the stretch.
And he only had 7 points last night in that victory against St. John. Zimmerman. He'll toss it up, missed that one. And now here's Akeem Ellis. Jahid Carson gonna try for the trade.
Oh, yes. Boys. Uh-oh, he's starting to feel it there, boys, now.
Hitting that one hard.
3-point game. Jahid Carson getting hot. What a decision by Akeem Ellis, Peter. Passed up a layup and had Terry Thomas on the other side for a long-range Jahid three. That could fire everybody up on this team.
Clink Scales. Missed there by Washington. Jahid almost lost it. And that's going to be a foul on Watson. So, yeah, that three-point shot there by Jahid Carson. Here it is right here. That's ignited the crowd.
Passed it backwards, still 2 feet behind, but he caught it in rhythm, right? That's a rhythm shot. Basketball players know what I'm talking about. You know, you catch it in rhythm, you just have to go from a high to low, let the shot go, just get direction properly, and it's going to go in. Look at Mike Leslie
Mike
on the
Leslie.
Floor.
Oh, he gets,
oh baby.
He gets
I got something
up.
For you, the ref says.
A T.
And they are frustrated, and I'll tell you what they're frustrated about. And it's they're saying that Jahid Carson is hooking people when he's got the ball. So he's such a good ball handler. He takes the other hand, and he's saying that they're hooking people around their back. And the Halifax Storm are talking about it. I didn't see it that time. Actually, I saw the Halifax team foul maybe once or twice. But Jahid Carson has when somebody gets close to him, he's a tendency to move his shoulders back and show the ref that he's getting hit. And that's what they're talking about right there. And Mike Leslie is fuming.
So timeout called. And the crowd's really getting into it now. Akeem Ellis is doing some cheerleading here. And the Storm back into it. 97-94, Halifax leading the Island Storm. Going to take a break. Back with more right after this.
What's my soccer ball? Well, the air inside, it has superpowers. There are tons of little teachers inside that help me learn about things like collaboration and perseverance. With each kick, those powers get a little stronger. I think it's made out of polyurethane, though.
Give them the chance to discover what their equipment is made of. Give them the chance to play. Visit sportnovascotia.ca to find out how you can help.
Did you know falls are the number one reason children in Atlantic Canada are hospitalized? Help make your home safer for kids of all ages. By using or installing a window stop, screens are not enough to prevent falls. Protect small children by using a screw-mounted gate at the top of the stairs. Be careful not to trip over your pets, and keep clutter and toys off of the stairs and floors.
We can all help our home be a safer place.
Welcome back, and there you see some of the fans. They're all jazzed up, and the reason they're jazzed up is because this Island Storm team, they've cut into this Halifax lead, and they're within striking distance, down 97-94.
Yeah, and that was Rachel and Sarah, two friends of mine from around. Yeah, they're really great people. They're here, and they're excited about this Island Storm team. They're on their feet again, so listen. Get out and support these NBL teams. Halifax, get out there and support
Definitely.
This team. There's something special about this team. And in Charlottetown, same thing. Get down here and get behind this Island Storm team as they go into playoffs.
I talked to three people the other day at the gym at UPEI. And their first experience taking in an NBL game. You know, sports fans probably went to UPEI games and watched some U-Sport basketball, and they were so impressed with the level of talent. And there,
baby.
That's why you're impressed with the level of talent, a player like Jahid Carson. Tied at 97 now.
And look at him getting back. This game is tied.
Unbelievable that the Storm have come back into this one. But there you go. There's an example why you got to come out and support this league and the teams in your community.
Look at that crossover. Left hand, that's not even his dominant hand. Like, he makes it look so easy.
Watson. Washington, a little bump there. Oh, that's Terry Thomas.
Two shots.
And that's going to be a foul, though.
Yeah, and watch it here. Bump once. You be the judge. Is that, you know, there's contact on that first bump, and on that second bump, there didn't
that looked
look
like it was all ball, right?
Yeah, it didn't look like much contact, but the ref saw the contact and said, okay, there's going to be a play at the rim, and there just wasn't for that call.
Foul against Mike Allison.
But you know what, Watt, for the young fans, look how low he was when he started to attack. CJ Washington, just please make your post moves look just like that, and you're going to be a good player.
Good hustle there by Washington. He tried to save that ball. Ran right into the padding.
Oh, man, I wish this game was like an hour longer. I'm enjoying it.
Yeah, it's been a great game here this evening in Charlottetown. And now Halifax with a one-point lead.
Oh, he got the corner.
Oh, can't get it to roll. Jaheed Carson.
He's going
to
get the foul call. Oh, he got the corner on that. And just a great, look at it. He's so pumped. He's like, yeah, I love Charlottetown. This is where I go to work, kids. Look at that.
So, yeah, goal 10 there.
And that's Billy White coming after. You know you got to get it up quick and fast or high and slow. It's just, you know, those are your two options.
99-98. Watson, Billy White.
Wants to go to work. Look at the speed.
Going baseline, and he ran out of track.
Wow.
Oh, Akeem.
Look at, they're going to talk. They're going to talk. He's Akeem. Talking to the coach.
Whoa, Akeem Ellis going right towards Mike Leslie and talking some trash.
He's fired up.
Whoa.
Man. Welcome, Halifax fans. Hope you're watching tonight. It's getting a good one today. He's going to shoot it.
Yeah, no. This finish is unbelievable. Whack misses. Mike Allison gets the rebound.
What a rebound. Keep that ball alive. Wow.
3:10 remaining in regulation.
They're really denying Jaheed Carson. They did not want him to touch the ball. See if he gets it on the weak side.
Ellis almost lost it. 8 on the shot clock. Oh. Great athletic effort right there from Akeem Ellis.
Got to get back.
Can't convert.
Oh, this is a mismatch. Huge mismatch there.
Inside for Watson.
Oh, he called the charge.
And a charge against Tyrone Watson, and he's in a bit of pain.
And look at Mike Leslie, has got a smirk like, you just stole my Corvette car right in front of me. That's the kind of look he has on his face. Watch this. You be the judge. Oh, Peter, you're looking at me like you want me to tell you what it is.
Tell me.
He was outside the restricted zone. He was moving slightly to his right, something the camera would have just picked up slightly. So it could have gone either way. I believe it might have been a block. But I don't have my reference certifications. But we're going the other way. Oh, what a pick. Clint Scales.
That's a costly turnover there. And Scales. Clint Scales.
Wow, the amount of skill that took. I've never seen anybody take the ball off of Jaheed Carson this season. And the amount of skill that took. So Clint Scales with a big play for his Hurricanes to put him up one.
2:30 remaining. And that was left short there. Rebound by Akeem Ellis. No foul. And Joe Salerno is, there's steam coming out of his ears. He wanted a foul call there against Halifax. Not going to get it.
Wow.
Clint Scales. Zimmerman.
Got to defend hard here. This shot cannot be an easy one inside.
The alley and the oop. Clink Scales and Billy White teaming up. Whoa.
That's exactly what I tried not to call.
Gee. So 102-99. Al Stewart trying to drive. Zimmerman is called for a foul.
And look, that play was off. That's a play that I've seen Halifax run constantly. Watch this. They'll fake the pass. No, don't even have to fake the pass. You cannot get on the high side of Billy White, and that's why. So defensively, you have to keep your body in front of his wherever he is. If you get on the high side of that and deny the ball too much, he's just going to go backdoor. And with a one-point game with 1 minute left to go, that's not the error that you can make.
So we've got a little conversation over the scorer's table. And now Terry Thomas will inbound the ball.
Look at the physicality on these screens. He's trying to get the ball to that guy right there. Two-man game with Baines.
Over to Ellis, another deep three opportunity, and he missed that one.
And that's the difference. You see, the Hurricanes are getting dunks and layups in one end, and then we're shooting, the Storm are shooting long balls, which he can hit. Okay, that's not the argument. Just you need to get something going to the basket, something aggressive.
Here's Poole. He wants to drive. Teardrop gets it to go. And Poole, wow, what a great second half he has had for Halifax.
And you see the difference when you're driving and penetrating to the basket. You get a small little floater. It's a quality of shots as the reason why this is a five-point game.
Wow, we're going to have a good finish on this contest here. 120 remaining, 104-99 for Halifax. Taking a break, coming back in just a bit.
Being part of an Easter Seals camp has really shaped who I am today. My dream is to see every kid in Canada living with a disability go to an Easter Seals camp so they can experience what I have experienced. See ability in disability. See the difference? Be the difference.
Text Easter to 45678. Make your $10 donation today.
Fans here in Charlottetown, they got bang for the buck in this one. They'd love to see their team leading right now, but they're in this one. 120 remaining, 104-99 lead for Halifax. Been a great game, Gordon.
Oh, it's been such a good game. And you know, this is the Storm had a one-point lead. Then Clinsdale's makes this great play. The Storm come down, taking maybe a shot that's ill-advised. Starts a fast break, a dunk by Halifax. This is how Halifax closes games. So you see that they're in a lot of close games, but they just need to be close, and they trust each other so much that they can finish the game in the last 2 minutes, and you're seeing why here today.
Keem Ellis. Al Stewart fakes the shot baseline. Kicks it out. Jahee Carson. Left that short.
Big rebound.
Stewart got the rebound. Akeem Ellis will try it. And he gets the three.
Yeah. Big fella hits his fifth three of the game. He's going over to talk to Mike Leslie. Get me on here. Sign me, coach.
My goodness. He is pumped up. And he's done that a couple of times now. Taunted that Halifax bench. You got to be careful there. You don't want to be getting a tee.
Watch this. After he hits a shot, I don't know where the clip ends, but he goes towards the Halifax bench. Beautiful shot. Look at that rotation. Still spinning.
Shows everybody that he hit the three.
He goes and looks at the Halifax coach, and he's like, yeah, I think I'll go over and talk to Mike Leslie and say, hey, you better put somebody on me here, coach. But they're just fired up emotionally, and the coaches know that. And, you know, that's what makes the league great. You want that kind of showmanship, that kind of excitement in your players, and that's what brings the fans out.
Somebody needs to tell Akeem Ellis they have brewed decaf now. I think he's getting an extra shot of espresso in his coffee.
Yeah, man.
That's a good thing.
Exactly.
And it's a good thing because right now the Storm down by two against Halifax, and boy, you would have thought in this fourth quarter these two teams would be dog tired. They played last night. The concrete legs would set in. That has not been the case.
No, and it's kind of, they're working very hard. I saw Mike Leslie work some plays that worked very well. His pick and roll system of basketball is working very well for his personnel. The Storm have really just played well and got behind this crowd tonight, and that's what's keeping them in the game. And that guy right there really came out in the fourth quarter and said, hey, you know what? I want to win this game.
And Jahee Carson now has 19 points, 8 of 14 from the field. And he's got seven dimes, too.
Yeah, just a good young player. So this is the one-on-one set here. So watch this for the screening action. This is what the Storm been struggling with. This is a one-on-one play. Look, here comes the double team. Rotation out of this.
Clint Scales.
Oh, this is a mismatch here. Clint Scales against the Storm's big man, Baines.
Sticks on the shot clock. He's going to drive. Yeah. Misses it. And that's going to be Storm ball with 39 seconds remaining.
And Clint Scales had the corner. He had the basket. He burned Baines, left him back there. And exactly what Leslie wanted. He just couldn't finish at the end. Ball was slippery.
Al Stewart going to direct traffic here.
If they score here, this place is going to go nuts.
Here's Terry Thomas from three-point range. Oh. Misses it. Can they get the rebound? No, they can't. And then Akeem Ellis fouls Clint Scales. And that shot was there for them, and he just missed it.
Yeah, you know, they got open looks. And as basketball players and coaches, that's what you want. Sometimes they go and sometimes they don't. But that was the look that the Storm were looking for. So Terry Thomas, like, he'd hit two. He's two for two from three thus far in the game. So to get that look, to go up one was awesome.
Need a stop here. You 27 need. Seconds remaining.
I'm going to try to look for a steal. There it is.
There's the steal. Can they get it?
There it is.
Terry Thomas.
Baby! Look it up! Woo!
And that's going to take the roof off this building right here.
Oh, yeah.
Jahi Carson with a big-time steal.
What?
And Agent 13 finishes it off. And we are tied at 104. Take a look at it.
Woo! Look at this, folks. Just working hard. Terry Thomas takes his time. Finishes strong at the basket. This place is more excited than Cavendish Music Beach Festival weekend.
And there's Terry Thomas. What a great game he has had. Terry Thomas right now, 28 points. So we'll come back. 18.5 seconds remaining. We'll give you the conclusion of this one. It's been a great one. Tied at 104. Back with more right after this.
Ronald McDonald House provides a place for families to stay when they have a child in hospital. It's a home away from home when you can't be near family and community support. It's a place to relax and connect with others. Ronald McDonald House also has family rooms at the IWK and in the Moncton Hospital for those who need a break or quiet place to pass the time. Families from all over Atlantic Canada are welcome. To learn more or make a donation, go to rmhatlantic.ca.
Welcome back, everybody. Gordon McNeely's about ready to jump for joy here, I think.
We're way up high. If I jumped, I'd land on some fans.
What a great game we've witnessed here this evening. Yeah. The Storm have fought back in this fourth quarter, and they now have a 104-apiece tie with Halifax.
This is great. This is what people come out to see. Look, the fans are on their feet. This league is completely rocking. These players are giving it them all. And you know what? That last play, Jahi Carson was playing defense. He was going to turn him once. What I was going to say is turn him once, turn him twice. If he couldn't get the steal, then you were going to see a foul. But he got the steal. So just well played, well executed.
18.5 seconds remaining in regulation. We're tied at 104.
I think they're going to hold for one shot. You're going to see some screening action up top. Clint Scales will come out and get it. He'll hold it. He'll hold it, and you'll see some screening at the end of this. Here it comes on the left side. It's too early. He went back, repositioned.
And there's over to Zimmerman.
Oh,
pass.
There's
here.
A shot.
Washington missed it. And boys, oh boys, what a game we have had here, and it's going to go to overtime. Tied at 104, and this crowd, they're feeling it.
Akeem Ellis was brought into play and to be the head cheerleader because his arms must be getting tired. But that's the excitement you want. Your team is going to overtime, big fella.
So what a game here. Oh. Halifax looked like they were going to run away with it in the fourth quarter, but Island Storm have had other thoughts, and they have played so much better defensively in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, they really got out and made things happen. Coach Salerno has taken the right timeouts, and they've adjusted from those timeouts. And really, some shots have gone their way. They're shooting the ball well at home. That's the way it normally goes. But listen, they're giving these Charlottetown fans everything they could ask for and then some. So this is the last regular season game for them here. And have they ever put on a show?
Now, despite the fact that Halifax has totally outclassed the Storm in the rebounding department, 59-33,
game
is going to overtime. That's a wide disparity.
Well, remember what we said? Remember we said in the second quarter, I was like, yeah, if you get out-rebounded, you better be shooting the ball well. And that's what we said in the second quarter, and the Storm have done that. They've shot the ball well, and that's allowed them to stay in this basketball game.
Yeah, I mean, they're shooting 44.6% from the field, 42 of 94. And then you have Halifax. They're shooting 50.6% from the field.
And I think the Storm would have gotten off, well, 38. Yeah, so we're just looking at some stats here. So the Storm actually have more field goals. And they have to have more field goals if you're going to get crushed on the glass like that. So it's three more field goals the Storm have, and that's 6 points. So, yeah, but right now you're starting again. Listen, 5 minutes left to go. Everything counts. You got to work hard on these screens.
Here's Poole. Terry Thomas all over him, and Poole gets called for the travel.
Yeah, and that's pressure defense, forced Poole to turn his back and travel. So, I mean, and that's Mike Poole. So Terry Thomas is defending a very good player, Mike Poole.
Airtight defense there from Agent 13.
I've calmed down now, Peter.
Relax. We need to get maybe a seatbelt here for you. Seatbelt with a harness.
I love basketball.
I thought you were going to fly over this table here.
No. I need a bungee cord. Here we go.
Thomas working on Poole. And knocked out of his hands by Poole. It'll be Storm ball with just 3 seconds remaining on the shot clock. And I think Joe Salerno wanted a foul.
Yeah, he wanted a foul. We can't see it from up here, but he was going away from us. But it looked like the left hand maybe. But it's overtime. You're not going to get those calls. And Joe Salerno knows, but he's got to keep trying anyway.
Wow, the intensity level of this game went up tenfold.
What?
Late stages of the fourth quarter.
There was shot clock.
Terry Thomas had to jack it up.
Good
almost
awareness.
Made it. Crowd asking for some D here from the Storm.
I don't like this. Al Stewart's guarding Klingsdale's on the weak side.
Zimmerman. Oh, nice pass, but can't finish. That was Washington that couldn't sink it.
Good touch rebound by Thomas.
Nice fake there by Ellis, his patented fake. And then Jaheed Carson drives and lays it in.
Wow, and that was challenging Billy White right at the basket.
All hands on deck here in the overtime.
And they're fighting much better through that screen.
Zimmerman. A little bit of a charge there on Stewart, no call, and then a long three by Poole, and now Poole, his turn to stare down.
Yeah, and that's an offensive rebound. Yeah,
Island Storm bench.
That's an offensive rebound, which hurts you.
Hakeem Ellis, yes! My goodness.
Wow. He is playing some kind of basketball game today.
He's playing out of his mind.
So offensive rebounds could have hurt you there, and you've got to make sure that they only get one shot, Halifax, here.
Keem Ellis, 5 of 12 from three-point range.
Oh, nice move.
And Billy White, he gets hacked, and he'll go to the line.
He's going there. He's going to the line quickly. I mean, that was a come-on-my-back team kind of move. Just aggressive right hand, used his back. Here's a three. Look at that catch from coming. The ball's coming towards you. You just don't have to square your shoulders. Just let it fly. Beautiful.
Billy White, he got into foul trouble, had to sit for an extended period of time. You look at his stat line here. Pretty impressive. 14 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 of 6 from the field. So that's been pretty.
Oh yeah.
That's pretty good when you consider that he sat for a long period of time with four fouls on him.
What a team guy. And there's another team guy on the other side is Al Stewart. Man, that was a delay. Hesitated, and he wants to get to the cup. So he's doing everything he can to get right there. And what a great take at a timely time. He hasn't scored very much today. Yeah, he's only got 2 points thus far, but that was a great take.
Al missed the first one.
So that counters against Billy's miss. He went 1-for-2 last possession. So
Al makes the second one. So 110-108 for the Storm here in overtime. Clink Scales, Billy White.
Look at the post position. Look at that post battle.
Wow, that's a battle right there between Washington and Baines. And that's going to be foul against, let's see. It's foul against Baines.
Yeah, and you know what? That could have gone either way. Those guys have been fighting all night. And I watched that. I just watched that specifically. And I, you know, watch the inside position. Look at the hands. You make the call. You know, look at that.
I'm wondering, though, why Gord... Coach Leslie, he looks like he's ticked off. He got the call. That's what he wanted.
Well, he's saying that my guys have been doing that all night. But, I mean, what he's not seeing is that they're initiating the contact way aggressively, way too aggressively for the basketball game. So they're setting the screen tough, and then the Storm have to react. And he's trying to get the call and the reaction. So it's just how you look at the game, and Mike sees that he's defending his players, which he needs to and has to. So he's doing the right thing there.
So Storm by 2, 2:15 remaining here in overtime. What a game we've had here in Charlottetown. Big time Atlantic Division matchup. Keem Ellis. Billy White trying to defend him. Keem Ellis gets it out. Baines from the corner. Yes. That shot has been money for Terrell Baines all evening.
Oh, man, you can say that again, Pierre. That was the biggest one of the night for him. Wide open, 16. You see how Billy White turns his hip there on the end of that screen? So it's just a matter. That's not a call, but that's a foul most of the time. So it's just how you see the game. Like, there's things there you could call, not call, but, man, four-point game, 134. This place is about to erupt.
Crowd is into it here in Charlottetown. Storm by 4. Beat St. John last night. Want to take down another unbelievable team here. And, oh, I thought that was a foul.
Yeah, and it's Mike Poole just pulled away right at the very end of that.
And speaking of Poole, he comes right back with a dagger.
Man. Drop the kids off at the pool there. That was a beautiful shot.
Storm now by 1. 112, 111, 104 remaining in overtime. Jahid Carson, Baines, fakes in the paint. Can't get the ball to go.
Wow,
under a minute now.
Oh.
It's gone back and forth here in this overtime frame. Here's Billy White.
Tough defensive, looking for an isolation.
Zimmerman.
Oh,
Zimmerman hits it. And now Joe Salerno, he's called a timeout. And boy, just like that, boom. Halifax has come back, and they've got a one-point lead with 43.5 seconds remaining. What a game.
Wow, and you just think back to Baines. You can't do anything else. Baines, shot fake, took it to the basket. It just hit that stupid back iron. And, I mean, there was nothing wrong with that take. It should have dropped for him. And then they come back the other way and nail a jump shot. So, you know, that's just the way basketball goes. You're talking about the basketball gods.
Yeah.
You've seen them today. So
let me tell you something, Gord. There's nothing minor league about what we're seeing here tonight. This is unbelievable ball. And the fans, they're getting a treat here in Charlottetown.
Yeah. No, there's nothing you could ask for anything better than this kind of basketball. Get out and support these teams, and especially in Halifax. I know they got great fans over there. And, you know, Cape Breton and St. John and all over the place. We've seen the Ontario teams come through. So this league is growing and getting better. So I'm just excited to be commentating it. And I try to stay in my seat, but I can't. I can't do it.
So 43.5 seconds remaining. It's the Hurricanes with a 113-112 lead. And right now for the Storm, you've got Jahi Carson, a Mesa, Arizona native, 21 points, 9 of 15 from the field, 9 dimes, 3 rebounds. And then Terry Thomas with 28 points. He's got 8 rebounds, 13 of 21 from the field. And Akeem Ellis, 30 points.
Oh, man.
10 of 20 from the field. He's 6 of 13 from three-point range.
And Billy White's guarding him. So, I mean, what a game, you know.
Leading the way from for Halifax, C.J. Washington with 28 points. Perfect. So 40 seconds remaining.
Here comes the screen right. They switched it, so watch this. So now he's going to try to take Billy White one-on-one.
Here's the jumper. Oh. Terrell Baines. He had the
they
ball.
Got the foul.
Yeah,
he got
the
foul.
He's going to go to the line.
Wow. So so they got the switch. Halifax decided to switch. It was a mismatch for Jahi Carson, who was at 5'11 versus the 6'11. That's a foot in the difference. Billy White. So Billy White's probably not. What is he, 6'9? Yeah.
So two big three throws here for Baines. Oh, left that one short. Left that one short.
I'm not talking about these free throws until they're done.
And gets the second.
So 28 seconds left to go. Timeout Halifax. We'll give you some scenarios coming out after this.
So 113 apiece. We're going to take a little break here. We'll come back. 28.1 seconds remaining in this overtime frame. All tied up. Back to Charlottetown in a sec.
Sorry.
Welcome back to Charlottetown, folks. This game has had a lot of rattle and hum. It's 113 apiece. Island Storm and the Halifax Hurricanes.
Yeah, and they're interacting well. This Island Storm team is interacting well with their fans. Listen, a couple scenarios. There's 28.1 seconds left to go. Halifax can do two things. They can shoot it early, or they can run the shot clock out. Regardless, the Storm are getting it back. All right, so you're going to try to go for two, get something that you can rebound. So you'll see them try to get into Clint Scales and then run a pick and roll off that and try to get something going to the basket and get the best shot you can possibly get.
Here's Clint Scales. 26 seconds remaining in this overtime frame.
They'll run some action, then they'll send their five-player or four-player up to set a screen. They're just waiting, so they're trying to take as much time off the clock. They kind of boshed that play just a fraction.
Think Scale's going to drive. Oh, that was a tough shot. Rebound. And a foul.
Wow. The offensive rebounding of this Halifax team is something to talk about. And they're going to the line. Cox, I do believe he missed his last two free throws. But these are two big free throws. So for the Storm, what you're thinking is we need to rebound this, and then we're going to – if you rebound the shot, there's no timeout. You got to go. You got 6 seconds left. But if he makes one or makes two, you can call a timeout and take it at center.
Two big shots from the charity stripe.
That's deep.
And Cox misses the first one.
So this is crucial to rebound this ball, and you're rebounding against a tough – Akeem Ellis is over there talking to somebody. Listen, you have one job to do, and that's keep Billy off the glass. Okay, they're switching positions down low.
Over there. Okay.
So this is a massive rebound. You got to find your point guard and push the ball. You have 2 point guards to go, Al Stewart, G. Carson, and you got 6 seconds. Okay.
Second one made by Cox.
They're not going to take a timeout. Go. There's the foul.
Oh. And a foul there on Zimmerman.
Yes. That could send him to the line. Just a terrible foul from Zimmerman.
Wow.
So listen, Peter. Zimmerman tried to cut him off at center, and I could see it, and there wasn't much room there, but you're trying to cut off the fastest guy in the league, and you just weren't there. So the referee blew the foul, and these are 2 shots. One for the tie.
So tied now at 114.
One more to put him up one, and this place is going to erupt. G. Carson, very good foul shooter.
There you go. You can hear a pin drop.
82% on the season. Up one. 4 seconds left to go.
Here we go now. Clink scales.
This is for the win.
And there you have it.
Woo-hoo.
What a game. What a game. Are you kidding me?
Look at this place.
Get out of town.
What a win for this Island Storm team and franchise. Look at Akeem Ellis.
Yeah, he's pumped up. 115, 114, the Storm come back, and they beat this Halifax team, a talented Halifax team, by one. Wow, what'd you think?
My gosh, I think that's the way basketball should be played. It's back and forth. Listen, the Storm lost the third quarter by close to 18 points and came storming back, and that's why they're called the Storm. This Halifax team is something special, and they're going to have a great big playoff run. Hopefully, we'll see these two teams in the NBL semifinal. That's a very much a possibility.
Well, a great way for the Island Storm to finish off their home regular season schedule with a big win against a real tough team. They've knocked off 2 giants in NBL Canada play. Last night, St. John, 104-92. They come back here with a 115-114 victory against Halifax. So there you see the Storm saluting the fans here in Charlottetown. A big, big win. Now they head on the road. They'll play tomorrow in Cape Breton. So a great game tonight. Glad you can join us. So on behalf of Gord McNeely and the entire 5TV1 crew, I'm Peter Ruckgazer saying so long from Charlottetown.